Tennessee, Alabama, the Volunteers, and the Crimson Tide, two football powerhouses molded by legendary coaches from bordering states. And on the third Saturday in October, for nearly 73 years, they have met to try to tilt the balance of power in the SEC. This season, Tennessee is once again in a frantic race for the East title. A team of both power and grace, the Vols hope a record-setting seventh straight victory versus the Tide will catapult them to another appearance in Atlanta. Alabama is a team still chasing the past. In order to stay alive in the West, a victory against Tennessee is imperative here on the third Saturday in October. Welcome you to the Home Depot SEC football on CBS. In the shadow of the Denny Chimes on the campus of the University of Alabama in Tuscaloosa, the Elephant Stomp, as the band parades down University Boulevard en route to the inside of Bryant-Denny Stadium, filled to capacity again this afternoon as the Tennessee Volunteers take the field. Listen to the wave and the roar as the Crimson Tide of Alabama takes the field. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Vern Lundquist along with Todd Blackledge and Jill Arrington. Not a bad scene, is it? The 84th renewal of this great rivalry between Tennessee and Alabama. Tennessee has won the last six in succession. No team has ever defeated Alabama seven times in a row. The SEC East standings as the Volunteers come in a logjam with South Carolina, Florida, Georgia, and they still have South Carolina and Florida yet to play. Over in the West, Alabama has lost its last two SEC games in the fourth quarter, but they are 3-3, and look at this game as a possible turnaround and a chance to accomplish something significant this year. Todd, interesting the mindset of both of these teams now, because in their last outings, they both lost fourth quarter leads.
Yeah, and if you want to be a good team, you must play well in the fourth quarter. That's not been the case with either team. Tennessee got away with it against LSU, but not so against Georgia. A real letdown in the last 44 seconds. Georgia able to drive the ball down and get the winning touchdown. And I was in Knoxville on Monday. They were still upset of how they let this one get away. Meanwhile, Alabama has blown double-digit leads in two games in the fourth quarter. Last week against Ole Miss, Eli Manning threw for 155 yards in the fourth quarter. And for Alabama, their problem is their offense has disappeared in the fourth quarter, and nobody has stepped up to make a play on the defensive side of the ball. If this game gets in the fourth quarter today, somebody has to step up and make a play.
I think you have the sense that the way this game is going to turn out is going to be dictated by the two quarterbacks.
Yeah, I think both quarterbacks have to play well for their team to win. For Tennessee, Casey Clawson, he's still young, and he's getting better each week. He's 9-2 as a starter, and the best way to attack this Alabama team is throwing the football. But I think that Casey has to be particularly sharp today because his wide receiving core, including his top target, Kelly Washington, not 100%. Meanwhile, Tyler Watts for Alabama has really had a strong year as both a runner and a passer. He did not throw the ball well last week against Ole Miss, but today it's important against the number one defense in the conference to keep him off balance, running the option, scrambling, and he must make some big plays throwing the football.
Could not be a more spectacular Saturday afternoon this third Saturday in October. A sellout crowd, the temperature in the mid-70s, not a cloud in the sky as we come to you from Bryant-Denny Stadium. Alabama won the toss. It's currently 76 degrees. Very slight humidity and a small breeze out of the southeast. Alabama did win the toss. They deferred in Tennessee will receive to open the game. 84th meeting, Tennessee, since winning in 1995, has won the last six. Here's Leonard Scott, the world-class speedster, but he has had horrible problems on kickoffs this year, averaging under 16 yards per return. Lane Bearden will kick off. The 3-3 Crimson Tide against the 3-1 Tennessee Volunteers. Scott moves up and grabs it at the 7. Skips out of one tackle into another, is down at the 30-yard line, but this is pretty good field position now for Casey Clawson and the Tennessee Volunteers. The sophomore from Northridge, California, it was a year ago this weekend that he got his first start for the Volunteers.
You know, the thing that I'm most impressed with what Casey is doing right now is he's been very patient. I mean, he is taking what the defenses give him, and you don't expect that as from a young quarterback, but he's been very patient in waiting for his opportunities to make throws down the field.
On the kickoff return, injured Alabama player. This is Adam Cox, one of the linebackers from Jasper, Alabama, down just inside the 25-yard line.
Boy, you hate to see that. Adam's a senior. You know this is a big game, a huge rivalry, and he's a valuable backup. Plays a lot as an outside linebacker. Watch right here in the middle of your screen. There's Adam Cox, 31. Block in the back, and hard to see what the injury was in that play, but he's going to try to get off the field on his own. Tough kid. You know he's going to do everything he can, Vern, to stay in this ball game.
You know, Adam Cox getting just a bit of assistance. Dennis Franchione in his first year, having come here from TCU, prior to that New Mexico, Southwest Texas State, hired December 4th last year after it was the decision of Mal Moore, the athletic director, to relieve Mike DeBose of his responsibilities as the head coach. First down and 10, Tennessee, and they've got the ball just outside the 30-yard line. Eric Parker is on the field. We were told he would not start, but he is out there, number 80. And here's Clawson and the Tennessee Volunteers. Bobby Graham comes to the near side. And that is Graham in motion, wearing number 11. Clawson will throw on first down. Swings it out. It is caught by the fullback, Will Bartholomew, number 45. Seldom used, mostly a blocking back. Well, let's check in with the third member of our crew. Here's Jill Arrington.
Well, Vern, this is the first time that Dennis Franchione has been a part of this Tennessee-Alabama rivalry, and he respects the tradition of this rivalry, but in the past, the players have worn orange practice jerseys. They blared Rocky Top during practice to get the team ready for this big game, but not this year. He decided to stay the course and just focus on beating this team.
Thank you, Jill. Travis Stevens stuffed on second down and 3. Tackle made by Cornelius Wortham, number 16. And let's set the offense now for the Volunteers up front. Reggie Coleman back in the lineup, sat out one with an injury. Weary, Wells, Herrera, and Travis Stevens, Bartholomew in the backfield. Graham and Scott, the wide receivers. John Finlayson, the blocking tight end.
New guy right here, the new nickelback for Alabama, Thurman Ward in the ballgame.
Thurman Ward at a 60-yard return of an interception against Arkansas back 3 weeks ago. Aries Monroe appeared to penetrate the neutral zone. On third down conversions, you see the first game, Syracuse, 0 for 14.
Offsides by the defense. 5-yard penalty, and that will result in a first down.
And just to complete the thought on the graphic, they have, in the last three games, 50% of their third down conversions, 26 of 52. There's Aries Monroe, who was judged to be offside. First down Tennessee at the 41-yard line. Play fake, Clawson lobs it out. It is caught by Jason Witten, the catching tight end. And Witten plunges down to the 40, perhaps the 39-yard line. That's a gain of 20 on first down.
Vern, aggressive defenses are susceptible to bootlegs, and that's exactly what Tennessee goes with. A nice play fake by Casey Clawson, hides the football. You get a defense running one way, little misdirection, and Jason Witten really starting to come on as a receiver for Tennessee. Finlayson is more the blocker. Witten, a valuable receiver.
And you see the game clock showing 15 minutes. It is inoperative right now, so they're keeping the time on the field. On first down, here's the handoff to Stevens. Quick opener over left tackle inside the 35. And into the arms of Salim Rashid, number 11, with Brooks Daniels there to help. Alabama's defense, Aries Monroe, Jarrett Johnson, Kenny King, and Kendall Moorhead, the linebackers, Salim Rashid, Wortham, and Brooks Daniels, and the secondary, which, Todd, may be the weakest part of this defensive unit.
Well, it's the weakest part, and I think it's even weaker today because Gerald Dixon, listed as a starter, did not participate in pregame warmups, has a stomach virus, and he was not on the field to start the football game, so problems increased for the Alabama secondary.
On second down, right side, that one's caught, and that is good news for Tennessee fans as Dante Stallworth makes the catch. Injured in the first game of the season and had a good week of practice. He's wearing a small cast you can see on his left wrist.
The thing I notice about the Alabama secondary is they play tentatively. They don't play with confidence. They give too much cushion. I mean, that's easy throw and catch for a quarterback like Casey Clawson. I mentioned he's patient, and he will keep throwing that quick hitch or that quick out as long as the defense gives it to him. But this Alabama secondary right now, and that was Roberto McBride that they worked on, they don't play right now with a lot of aggressiveness, a lot of confidence. They give up that cushion, and teams have really hurt them.
Tennessee has used its first timeout. They stop the clock with the ball at the 20-yard line and a first down and 10. Gorgeous October afternoon and a first down 10. Tennessee, they'll go from the spread formation, three receivers wide left. The tight end is Witten. He is split off wide right.
Troy Fleming, the fullback in the game, a very good receiver, number 27.
Comes the blitz from Kendall Moorhead in the end zone. Caught, touchdown. Dante Stallworth, 21 yards. Clawson has hit his first four passes.
Really nice job. Really nice job by Casey Clawson surveying the field and seeing the matchup. Here's what he had. One-on-one, Stallworth against McBride. He goes with his guy. No free safety help, up over the top. Beautiful throw. And you see he can still catch the ball with that bulky cast. He makes sure by cradling it in his arms. Nice job by Dante Stallworth.
And here's Alex Walls for the extra point. It is up and good. And a most impressive opening statement from the Volunteers of Tennessee. Dante Stallworth from Casey Clawson, Volunteers up by 7. Kelly Washington, who has been a sensation, particularly in the last two games, did not see action, Todd, in that drive.
Well, he's got a little bit of a stress fracture, the beginning of a stress fracture in his left foot. He did not practice at all this week. Now, he looked pretty good in warm-ups, but he's a guy that they don't know enough about him yet in terms of his pain tolerance. He ran around in warm-ups. He looks okay right now, but surprised that he wasn't in on the field on that particular touchdown play.
Tennessee, Alex Walls will kick off, and here's Freddie Millins, drifts back, and he is 5 yards into the end zone, takes a knee, and will come out to the 20. Provided these spectacular views of Tuscaloosa and Bryant-Denny Stadium is the Saturn Lightship. Today marks the first appearance of the Saturn Lightship on a regular season college football game. It's nice to have them with us. 11 minutes, we are told, remaining in the first quarter of play. Again, the scoreboard clock inoperative, so time being kept on the field. And here is Tyler Watts, junior quarterback for Alabama. They will open from the shotgun, first and 10 from the 20. He's rushed for more than 100 yards each of the last three games. And tries to hand it off on first down and 10, and my gracious. Ahmad Galloway nailed by John Henderson.
Well,
now let's check the Alabama Crimson Tide offense. It's Britt Smiley, Ephraim Portis, and Mathis up front, three redshirt freshmen. Galloway, Lau in the backfield, Millens and Carter the wideouts, and the tight end is Terry Jones.
Vern, you mentioned it. That's a key for Alabama. Three redshirt freshmen on the front line against the best defensive line in the Southeastern Conference, maybe in the country, when they're all healthy.
On second down, here's Watts, right side behind Millens, but he makes the grab at the 25-yard line. They get seven back. And defensively for this Tennessee Volunteer team, Jackson Henderson, the Outland Trophy winner, Haynesworth and Constantine Ritzman. The linebackers are Moore, Stevenson, and Whiteside. And the secondary, Jabari Greer, number 33, we're told, having a terrific year.
This is still a very talented defense, but they're playing without perhaps one of their two best players. John Henderson, probably their best, but Will Overstreet, really the emotional leader of this defense, still out with a knee injury.
Might get him back next week against South Carolina. They think probably more likely is Notre Dame. Here's the option for the first time. And Santonio Beard breaks through, first down, Alabama at the 40-yard line.
This is what Tyler Watts has to do. He's got to read the defense. He's got to check to the right side to run the option, and then they're going to option this man. If he takes the quarterback, pitch the ball. And then Santonio Beard has blocks here, and the fullback. That's good execution on the option by Alabama, and a big first down.
Sophomore from Nashville, Tennessee, picks up 17 yards and a first down, Alabama at the 41-yard line. Millen's the motion man again. Here's Watts, play action, steps up, hit as he lets it go, and is incomplete. Under heavy pressure, Tyler Watts.
He tried to go misdirection and get Ahmad Galloway out of the backfield, but good pressure up the field from Alabama. Again, this defensive front, very, very active. That was Stevenson coming on a delay blitz from his middle linebacker position. But the pressure from Henderson is what created the disruption in the play.
Santonio Beard is the only man in the backfield now behind Tyler Watts. Second and 10.
How deep the Tennessee linebackers are playing, really trying to be aware of the option.
And here is the option coming left this time. Watts keeps and is dropped after a modest gain of two. Stevenson and Albert Haynesworth combining for the tackle.
You can see right away, John Chavis, one of the things he's going to try to do defensively, keep his linebackers away from the line so they can run to the football. When they see their assignment on the option, in this case Stevenson had the quarterback, he gets there in a hurry. John Chavis has had 2 weeks now to prepare for the option. When you only have 1 week and you don't see it very much, it can be really difficult. But they've had an off week, an extra week of preparation for this Alabama offense.
Third and nine, Alabama. Galloway out of the backfield. Here's Watts looking
got a man deep.
He sure does. Way downfield is Carter, and Carter has the grab. Antonio Carter.
Vern, if Tyler would have seen him sooner, he'd have had a touchdown. He picked him up late, and for some reason, a real breakdown in the Tennessee coverage. They just let Antonio Carter get right behind him. Defensive backs looking at the ball. The safety takes a bad angle. Julian Battle, a poor angle to the football, and Carter just slips behind him. Heads up by Tyler to find him and get a big play for Alabama. But just a poor play or an angle by the safety, strong safety, Julian Battle.
There is a Tennessee player injured back at the 35-yard line. Carter with a grab of 45. And this is Rashad Moore.
Rashad Moore coming off. He looks to be okay. You know, one of the things, Vern, and maybe why the play like that happens, is with a quarterback like Tyler Watts, when he starts to scramble, he's been such a good runner. I mean, he's the fourth leading rusher of quarterbacks in the country. When he gets outside the pocket, you automatically maybe think he's going to run. But he did a nice job of that time scrambling in order to throw, keeping his eyes downfield and making the play.
A 45-yard gain, first and 10. And Lau and Beard are the setbacks in the eye. Sam Collins, the lone wideout, he's to the right side.
A lot of checking at the line of scrimmage by the Alabama quarterback.
Here's the option again. Watts cuts it inside, keeps it to the 9-yard line. Well, Todd mentioned the list of leading quarterback rushers. Keith Boyer of Air Force. That's pretty typical of an Air Force quarterback.
Well, they're a true option team, a triple option team. Woody Dantzler, an offense very similar like this at Clemson. Eric Crouch, more a pure option type team at Nebraska. Nebraska's quarterback's always up there. And It's been a long time since an Alabama quarterback has run the football as much or as well as Tyler Watts is doing this year.
Second down and 6 from the 8. Galloway is back in the backfield. They give it to Galloway. Play fake. Into the corner it goes, and he had a man. It's incomplete for Donnie Lau, who was again open for a second.
That's the second time they've tried to get a back out of the backfield isolated on a linebacker, and this was just too high of a throw. They try to slip the fullback out after the play fake, and Tyler just has to stick that one right at him. He had him open. When you get a guy that open, throw it right to him. Don't lead him at all.
Incomplete, 3rd and 6. They have not allowed a rushing touchdown in the season. Only 17 in the last 38 games. It's 3rd down, an obvious passing down here. And Watts spreads the field. He's got McCadley, Carter, and Collins wide left, and Millens all alone to the right side. Watts puts it down and struggles inside the 10, gets back to the line of scrimmage, 4th down.
Not a bad decision by Tyler Watts. That was excellent coverage by the Tennessee defense. You don't make a mistake by throwing it into coverage. Protect the football and kick a field goal. Here's Antonio Carter. Not open at all. Jabari Greer's got him covered. Tried to move with the scramble, but that's just good coverage by Tennessee and a smart decision by Tyler Watts.
Neil Thomas, 10 of 13 for the season. This will be from 26 yards away out of Jonathan Richey's hole to put Alabama on the board. And it's perfect. The highlight of the drive, a 45-yard pass reception by A.C. Carter. Thomas for 3. It's 7-3. Clock now official, 6 minutes and 35 seconds to go, first quarter, and good for all of us that the scoreboard clock is now deemed official. Lane Bearden will kick off. Alabama goes 72 yards, 10 plays, the highlight of which was the 45-yard catch by A.C. Carter. Leonard Scott is the deep man, got it out to the 31 on his first effort, gathers this one at the 5. Adam Cox, who was injured on the opening kickoff, good news, is back on the field. He's a part of that tackle. And Scott is tackled at the 25. Well, regional football coverage for you. The NFL on CBS tomorrow. Pittsburgh, Tampa, New England, the Colts, Baltimore, Cleveland, Tennessee, and Detroit. And then the late game, Denver will be at San Diego and Kansas City at Arizona. It all begins with the NFL Today tomorrow, 12 noon Eastern time. And Kelly Washington, not a part of the first series, is on the field now on 1st and 10.
Up at the top of the screen.
And now the key to him and covering him is trying not to give him single coverage too often.
Travis Stevens out of the backfield, darts back to his left. Nice cutback by Stevens. And he picks up a quick 12. Has been durable this season and is averaging 147 yards per game.
Yeah, it's a great story. It really is. I mean, here's a guy that has been so patient, waited his turn, elected to take a kind of a late redshirt year, and is just having a banner season in his final year here at Tennessee. He worked extra hard this offseason, and it is really paying dividends for him and for Tennessee right now.
4 wide receivers now on 1st and 10 after that 12-yard pickup. Clawson out of the backfield to Stallworth. Good downfield blocking. And Dante Stallworth skips across the 45 and tackled at the 46.
Tennessee really likes this play. It was a play that was pretty much popularized by Purdue with Drew Brees, but it's a little bubble screen. You get it quickly to a wide receiver, and then you get your other wide receivers blocking. It's almost like a running play out there, and you see a good block by Bobby Graham, the other wide receiver on the outside, that sprung Dante Stallworth. And right away you see the effects of having Dante Stallworth back in the lineup for Tennessee. They have more than one passing game threat.
2nd down and 1, they'll run the lead draw, and Stevens nears the 50-yard line. That'll be good for a 1st down and 10. And it's time now for our Exxon and Mobil virtual playbook.
Well, if you want to play Tennessee, you've got to stop their bread and butter play, and that is the ISO to the tailback. Travis Stevens ran it right there, and it's a very hard-nosed play, a double team with the center and the guard, the fullback leading through the hole, and then Travis Stevens does the rest. Every Tennessee back has run this play, and everything Tennessee does kind of stems off their ability to run the football in that play.
On first down 10, the Volunteers will go out of the spread again. Clawson is hit 5 for 5. He'll scramble on this one. Tucks it. Well, he's got the second base slide down. This predominantly crimson tide crowd. I think those were hoots of derision.
Well, plus they're used to watching a quarterback wearing number 14 in red that doesn't duck for anything. You know, he's running the option. He's getting banged all over the place. But that's not a bad decision for Casey Clawson. Get what you can get and get down.
Second down 8, 7-3, Tennessee.
Well, the matchups just do not favor Alabama in the secondary when Tennessee spreads them out like this.
Gerald Dixon is on the field now, battling that stomach virus. He is at left corner. The handoff up the middle goes to Stevens. Nothing. Salim Rashid, number 11, the middle linebacker, with the tackle.
The key to these linebackers is they are extremely quick. Watch Rashid. Read the play. And then just quickness gets right underneath the block into the backfield. He was met there along with Cornelius Wortham. And this linebacking core, very, very fast for Alabama.
Third and 8, Volunteers with a 7-3 lead.
Kelly Washington down at the bottom, down here against Gerald Dixon.
Dixon locked up tight on him. Clawson flushed right. Jarrett Johnson got a little bit of pressure, and there is the tackle. Brooks Daniels, and it'll be fourth down.
Nice job of coverage that time by Alabama. They chose to double cover Kelly Washington, and that is where Casey Clawson was going with the football. You see Dixon's got him on one side. The safety's going to help Reggie Miles, so they got two defenders, and Clawson made a good decision to scramble but couldn't get the first down. Or awful close anyway.
Now they called for a measurement to see if he picked up enough. Just an eyeball looks like maybe not.
See, one of the problems when you make a commitment to double cover any receiver, you're removing another defender that can stop a run or a scramble. And Casey Clawson recognized that, couldn't go where he wanted to go with the football throwing it, so decided to run.
Got about a foot. Tennessee, in establishing this 3-1 season record, has only gone for fourth down once prior. They were successful on that, so it would appear they're going to go for the first down. Fourth and 1 from the Alabama 41-yard line.
Part of this decision, you think you can run the football, you got a good offensive line, and your defense is the best in the conference if, in fact, you don't make it. Look to see him go to the left behind Fred Weary and Reggie Coleman, though, on this play.
Troy Fleming is in as the fullback now with Travis Stevens, the deep back. And they're loaded up to the left with Bartholomew as a wingback. Stevens, stuck.
I don't think he got it. Salim Rashid plays this play as well as anybody I've seen in college football this year. They get penetration inside, and then he dives over the pile right into the tailback. I've seen him do this in 2 or 3 ball games this year. Now, it's got to have penetration inside, but then Rashid jumps and meets the back right in the hole. Kendall Moorhead, yeah, Moorhead got the penetration, and then Rashid right there at the jump along with Brooks Daniels. This is going to be awfully close. No. A big plus for Carl Torbush's defense. This is a defense that struggles with confidence a little bit the last couple weeks. What a huge play to get the 4th-and-1 stop. And Brooks Daniels and Salim Rashid, an excellent play coming over the top.
From the 41, Bama holds. First down, Tyler Watts. He's got Lau and Galloway in the backfield. Ahmad Galloway, the junior from Millington, Tennessee, one of 6 Tennessee natives on this Alabama squad.
They asked the quarterback to do a lot at the line of scrimmage, check to a lot of plays.
Here's Watts, brings it for Millens over his head. Julian Battle up defensively. And it will be second down and 10. We'll go back to New York and get an update. Here is Tim Brendo.
Vern, like Alabama, Oklahoma's last loss was to Ole Miss 20 games ago. We'll hear new starting quarterback Jason White to Mark Clayton, 45 yards, a key play that led to a White plunge. Bobby Stoops unafraid to make a change at quarterback, even though he's won 19 straight, fellas.
Well, that kind of protection there, I think Tim Brando could even complete a pass.
let's not stretch this too far. Second down and 10. Millens will go in motion across the backfield. Watts, he's under pressure, pulls it up, and manages to get 3 yards. Now, fourth down, great stop from Salim Rashid.
Yeah, I mean, he has really played that play well, and I think that's the only time that they got the stop. He's done the same thing about four times this year, but they've always gotten the first down. This time, they got the stop, and he celebrated.
Third and 7. Triandos Luke, I'm sorry.
This is not the situation that Alabama wants to be in a lot. Third down and 7 or more. They want to have a shorter yardage so they can use the option if equally as much as running or throwing the football.
Luke is split wide right on third down. Here's the option. Oh, dangerous pitch. And Galloway is going to be nailed for no yardage at the 44-yard line.
The key to defending the option, Vern, is everybody has an assignment, okay? Somebody has to take the quarterback and somebody has to take the pitch man. So watch as this develops. You see discipline, there's the quarterback defended, and now here comes the man to take the pitch man. That's very good discipline by Tennessee. They had their assignments and they held their ground.
Lane Bearden on the punt, Rashad Baker is the deep man. He awaits it at the 20-yard line. Nice and high, good punt. Baker drifts back, grabs it at the 16. There's a tackle missed on the first attempt, but Brooks Daniels leads the charge. Sean Toure was also down there. A 41-yard punt and 3 on the return for Lane Bearden. Get the scoop on the SEC and see where your team ranks in the Sportsline 117 power rankings. Just go to cbs.sportsline.com or AOL keyword CBS Sportsline. Gorgeous setting on the campus in Tuscaloosa. This, by the way, is only the second time in the last 70 years that Tennessee has played this game in Tuscaloosa. It was traditional to play it in Birmingham, but the game was moved here in 1999 and will be a fixture here and in Knoxville on the third Saturday in October for a long time. 2 years ago, the game played here for the first time since 1930. Volunteers behind T. Martin's 2 touchdown runs cruise to a 21-17 victory. After the game, listen to this. They were mocking the Lynyrd Skynyrd song of Sweet Home Alabama, and that still rankles with the faithful here among the Crimson Tide followers. 107 to go, opening stanza, 7-3 Tennessee.
You know, one thing about this day today, it is a beautiful day for football, but I think it's actually a little unseasonably warm, and I think teams at this time of the year are not expecting to play on a hot day, and I think early in the ball game it'll be important to for both teams to substitute and keep their guys fresh, make sure they stay up on their fluids, because normally when you get into this part of the season, you don't have many hot days left, and today is a very warm day down on the field.
Average yards on first down, look at this, 11.4 for Tennessee in the early going. First and 10 here, backs in the eye. This is Bobby Graham, who starts in motion and sets up. They hand it off to Travis Stevens for 2. Todd was talking about Travis Stevens' career at Tennessee. He actually became a starter his freshman season for 4 games, but he had fumble problems and was benched and gave way to Travis Henry. And then after not playing in the first game in 1999, he went to Coach Fulmer and said, I'd like to redshirt. Mm-hmm. And he did, set out that season and patiently waited. Travis Henry last season with a brilliant year, and now Travis Stevens is having a sensational season.
And I think he surprised the coaching staff with his durability.
Comes right. Nice open field stop by Jason Rawls, redshirt freshman number 43. And Travis Stevens, not as large as the previous running back core.
No, but look at this, though. He has actually averaged more carries per game than even of his two predecessors. I mean, he has really done a great job in the weight room in the offseason, and his durability has been the biggest surprise. I don't think Tennessee expected that. They went out and sold, recruited about three Parade All-Americans as freshmen this year, and none of them can get on the field because Travis is playing so well.
That is the end of the first quarter with our score, Tennessee 7, Alabama 3. We'll return to Tuscaloosa after this message and a word from your local station. Welcome back to Bryant-Denny Stadium on the campus, University of Alabama. Tennessee leading 7-3 as we get set for the start of quarter number two. And Casey Clawson and the Volunteers look at a 3rd and 7 from the 21-yard line. Four wideouts now in the spread formation. Alabama brings 5. Clawson, perfect. First down, Tennessee at the 31-yard line. Dante Stallworth makes another grab and a welcome back for Tennessee fans. Stallworth with the 1 touchdown so far. Todd, your first quarter impressions.
Well, then Casey Clawson is doing what he has to do for Tennessee. He hasn't missed a pass yet. He's 6 for 6. They've got Dante Stallworth back. Kelly Washington's not 100%, but Stallworth is kind of making up for it right now.
The Volunteers leading by a 7-3 count and a fresh series of downs now at the 31-yard line. Clawson a perfect 6 of 6. Hand off Stevens, gets a good seal block and comes left. Works his way out to the 40-yard line. Fine run and a good block on the left side of that offensive line. Auburn taking on La Tech. Tim Brando knows about that. Here's Tim.
First, so does Alabama know about Louisiana Tech. They lost to them in 97 and 99. Now they set their sights on Auburn. A slow draw out of the shotgun by John Simon brings them to within 11. And Georgia holds on to beat Kentucky. You guys will have them in the old cocktail party next week.
I think you and Spencer ought to come down and join us. 7-3, Tennessee leads it. Bartholomew and Fleming in the backfield now. Here's Clawson, deep right side. He's got man coverage and just overthrew Dante Stallworth, who had about a foot and a half.
Nice decision, though, by Randy Sanders. It's 2nd down and 1. You like your running game. You've got one-on-one coverage. Stallworth against McBride, and he beats him right off the ball. That's all you need. That's all the separation you need. But Clawson just a little bit too far and a little bit too inside with that play. That's the 4th time now that they've gone after Roberto McBride. This is a secondary that really they're trying to find the guys that can come up and make plays and play with some confidence, and it hasn't been easy for Alabama.
Kelly Washington on McBride. The handoff goes to Stevens. He's got room. He is gone, and there are no flags down.
We talked about his durability. We talked about his strength and his power. We've seen that today. This play, we see his ability to make people miss. Brooks Daniels is going to be the first guy to miss him. Number 18, right there. And then look at that move. Sticks the right foot in the ground, leaves Reggie Miles standing still, and takes it to the end zone. That is an outstanding run by Travis Stevens.
60 yards. On the ground for Travis Stevens. And here is Alex Walls. And he kicks it into a sea of orange. All of the Volunteer fans gathered in that end zone. Look at the move on Reggie Miles. 14-3 Volunteers. Six plays, none bigger than the 60-yard touchdown dash from Travis Stevens. And Kelly Washington on the field on that play.
Yeah, and he's very lucky that he didn't get called for a holding, because that is flat out a takedown on Roberto McBride. Now he's going to pull the hands off and say, oh, no, no, I didn't hold. I didn't hold. It's a good block. Stay down there, Roberto.
One, two, three. The kickoff from Walls taken by Freddie Millins, who gathers it at the 2-yard line. And he is nailed as he gets to the 15-yard line. Tackle made by Mark Jones. And another view from overhead, these spectacular views, Bryant-Denny Stadium. Coming to you from the Saturn Lightship, the newest member of the Saturn team.
One of the things that Philip Fulmer said they spent a lot of extra time on in this off week was improving their special teams. And that loss to Georgia, they had some real breakdowns in the special teams. They had a punt return for a touchdown by Damian Gary. They missed a field goal right before the half and a couple bad squib kicks and coverage. So far today, a pretty good effort.
First and 10, 14-3 Tennessee. Galloway, the lone setback, and this one's going to be a delay of game. Nevertheless, the hit on the QB.
Yeah. All you got to say is you couldn't hear the whistle, because obviously Tyler Watts didn't hear it and Eddie Moore didn't hear it either. So just one extra shot on Tyler Watts.
Delay of the game on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
First down's really been hurting Alabama right now, Vern. I mean, they've got to be productive on first down so that the option is a valuable weapon when they get to third down. If they are not effective on first down and they're faced with a lot of third and seven or more, it's going to be really difficult for them. And there you see, averaging a half a yard on first down in the ball game.
Out of the spread on first down 15. A pump, and Watts has a little room now coming to the right side.
Flag down though, Vern.
Yep, back at the 3-yard line.
In the spot where you would anticipate holding on the Alabama offensive line.
And this one might negate a 16-yard scamper by the quarterback, Tyler Watts. Here's our referee, Steve Landis, who will confirm what we suspect already.
Holding by the offense, half the distance of the goal, repeat first down.
Take another look at this touchdown run from Travis Stevens.
Well, the key for Alabama, they had everybody crowd around the line of scrimmage, so there was nobody once Travis Stevens got past that first line. And just, again, terrific move on the safety mile.
Out of the eye with three wideouts, it's first down and 20 from the 5. Hand off Galloway. Another flag thrown on the far side of the field. Dennis Franchione, 50 years of age, first year here. Illegal formation against the offense. Well, Franchione, you might have heard Tim Brando's conversation with Dennis Franchione on the pregame show, where he referred to him as the captain of the turnaround. He has done a terrific job at every stop along the way.
And he's done it in tough places. I mean, places that have not traditionally been easy places to go in and win. Particularly New Mexico and TCU, and has done an outstanding job. And one of his trademarks has been disciplined football teams, and right now the fourth penalty already in this game against Alabama.
Play fake, pressure, Watts over the middle to the tight end, Terry Jones Jr.
What a huge play. Great play by Tyler Watts, knowing he's going to get hit, and a heck of a catch by Terry Jones in the middle of the field. It's a blitz by Tennessee. Watch the hit that Watts takes right as he gets rid of the football. And Terry Jones reaches back and makes the catch. And not only that, but puts a great shot on Rashad Baker. There's Terry Jones Sr., strength and conditioning coach, and as we found out yesterday, also the move back coach.
Yeah, he's the get back coach. His response, get back, get back. We don't want to be penalized. Third down now after the 18-yard gain. Backs in the eye. Here's the option, and the nice pitch goes left. First down, Alabama, Santonio Beard. They have escaped a huge hole.
The key to this play here is the block by the fullback, Donnie Lau. Watch Donnie Lau right behind the quarterback. Watch 49 get a nice block as the ball's pitched. Right on the right of your screen, there's the cut block right there. And that enables Beard to get outside. Without that block, the play's well defended. Good execution by the fullback, Donnie Lau. Quarterback has to pitch, and you must get the blocks on the perimeter, and Donnie Lau did.
Gain of 9, first and 10, Alabama. Quarterback draw. Watts. Well, they've done their homework. This extra week off, Tennessee looking very well prepared defensively for the most part. Now let's go back and check in once again with Tim Brando.
All right, fellas. Oklahoma's Ronaldo works. Well, Tulsa's Booker T. Washington High, former home of Spencer Tillman, can be awfully proud of this young man. Takes it in from 17 yards, 24-7, the defending champions over Baylor in the second. Back to you.
Now, thank you, Tim. As we went away, you saw an indication that a flag had been dropped, and this would be a penalty against Tennessee.
Take a look at the end of the play. It's John Henderson, a little tangled up, and Wesley Britt. They got the personal fouls on Tennessee. I don't think it was on Henderson there. It must have happened somewhere else.
No, that was just a poor version of a Tennessee waltz.
Yeah. A couple of dancing bears.
First and 10 after the flag, and the ball is out at the 50-yard line. 14-3 with 12:20 to go in the first half of play. There's the option again. Watts, good pursuit. Nice job defensively by Tennessee.
One of the things that totally destroys an option is penetration into the backfield along the line of scrimmage. In this case, Constantine Richmond, the guy who is in there for Will Overstreet, got great penetration right across the line, and Tyler Watts nowhere to go with the football.
Loss of 1, second down 11. Second and 11 in a 14-3 game. Alonzo Ephraim over the ball. Watts rolls right, puts it out in a hurry to Galloway, and he shakes the tackle, is down to the 44. That's going to bring up a third down. It was Eddie Moore who missed it. Well, we talked about the turnaround capacity of Dennis Franchione. Here's more from Jill. Jill?
That's right. One of the things that Coach Franchione has done is he has built a leadership council, and it comes up of one player per position on this council. He goes to them for input. It builds a sense of responsibility and accountability with the team.
He's done well. Handed out a 182-page manual to every player and every staff member when he took over back in December. Here's Watts backing up. Looks deep for Triandos Lope, and there's Millens, and a flag will be thrown. The trailer on a crossing pattern underneath Freddie Millens as they cleared it out by sending Luke deep.
And this was an unnecessary penalty on Teddy Gaines, Vern, because this ball was over the head of Freddie Millens. He was not going to make the catch. Tennessee was very well prepared for this play. And Teddy Gaines, there's no way Millens is going to make that catch, and he reached up and grabbed him, and he didn't need to. They were in position, they had it defended, and they give up the first down on the penalty. You know, I think that play, the play action off the option, is the most devastating play for an option football team, the hardest to defend. But Tennessee was well prepared for it that time.
Philip Fulmer in his 10th year as the head coach at his alma mater.
See, what Phillip's saying is that was not a catchable pass. He wasn't going to be able to make that catch. And I don't think he would have made it either. Unnecessary penalty on Gaines.
First down at the 29. Here's play action again. Watts gets a good block from his right tackle. Goes in the end zone for Collins. Got it. Touchdown, Alabama. Sam Collins.
This is a a great case of a receiver adjusting with his quarterback when he scrambles. Sam Collins is running down the field on a post. He looks back and he sees his quarterback scrambling. So he goes to the corner of the end zone and Tyler Watts puts the ball in a perfect place. That is great communication by the receiver and the quarterback against the scramble.
29-yard catch, second of the season for Sam Collins. Neil Thomas hammers home the extra point.
He caught his first career touchdown pass last week against Ole Miss. He gets his second one today against the Volunteers.
CBS Sports coverage of the Home Depot SEC football will continue after this word from your local station. Alabama. 10:38 to go, first half of play, an 85-yard drive in eight plays, and the 29-yard catch by Sam Collins to make it 14-10. Here's Bearden with a kick. Leonard Scott drifts to his left, has it at the five. Spins out of a tackle and is down as he gets to the 23-yard line. Tonight on CBS, former Senator Elliott Baines takes his three daughters to Washington, D.C. for a special moment with the leader of the free world. Don't miss an all-new Citizen Baines tonight on CBS.
You know, Vern, this is why you teach young receivers never give up on the play. Now, he's not open now, but he looks back and he sees his quarterback in trouble, and he keeps playing. He keeps playing, he keeps hustling, and Tyler Watts finds him for the touchdown. That's good heads-up play by Sam Collins.
Volunteers first down at the 23 with a four-point lead. Bartholomew turns around to make sure that Stevens had the audible. And a nice job by Travis Stevens of darting to his left and then back to his right into the hands of Charles Jones, number 20.
And one of the things that you see with Travis Stevens that you did not see with Travis Henry or Jamal Lewis is his cutting ability. I mean, this is a guy that can really put his foot in the ground, change directions without losing speed, and make people miss. And he's coupling that with some toughness that I don't think a lot of people in the SEC thought that he had.
Now, 41 carries against Arkansas, 34 against LSU, and 30 against Georgia. Second down. Left side it comes, a little screen pass, and it's caught out here on the left. All the way out to the 43-yard line. Montrell Jones, a highly touted freshman, and that is his first catch of the season. Streaky series. Well, Tennessee won undefeated in six games, rather, back in the early 60s. You see, most recently, Alabama had gone 9 in a row with an unbeaten streak, and now Tennessee going after its 7th. There's Bobby Graham in motion. Clawson puts it on his hip, gets a block, puts it out into the flat, and it is caught by his big tight end, John Finlayson. That's his first catch of the year for the three-time academic All-SEC player.
And I think it's a good call by Randy Sanders, because normally when Finlayson's in the game, you expect run. He fooled him up a little bit and called the bootleg that time with Finlayson in the game and not Witten. He's a big guy, 6'4", 275 pounds, excellent blocker, and showed some ability as a receiver on that play.
Already has graduated from Tennessee with a degree in agricultural economics. Here's the stretch of the chain and a first down, Tennessee. 8:58 to go. Well, Volunteers have won 6 in succession against Alabama. That equals a string that goes back to the turn of the last century. First down and 10.
Vern, Casey Clawson's really playing well in this ball game. I mean, he is managing the game. He's playing with poise, and he's been very accurate throwing the football.
They give it to the deep back, Stevens.
Look at that strength.
Yes.
I mean, again, we talked about he's got the ability to make you miss, to change directions, and that time he's dragging defenders for about 5 yards.
Well, the highlight of your week every Saturday afternoon, it is time now for our Aflac question of the week. Aside from Tennessee, who was the only other team to defeat Alabama 6 straight times? You and I know this one. Yeah, we don't have to guess. Just the depth of our research. second down. Here's the reverse coming left. Nice job by Jones. Charles Jones stayed home and made
yes,
the tackle.
He did, Vern. Excellent point. Tennessee thought they could fool him that time. Tennessee thought they could catch him off guard, catch him chasing the play, but watch Charles Jones stay at home and defend the reverse. He reads it, he stays in a breakdown position, and he makes a nice open field tackle.
Third and four.
Big play right here for the Alabama defense. These cornerbacks need to challenge. They need to get up and challenge.
Play clock down to three, yep. And Clawson has to use a timeout. Tennessee uses the second of three. Time called, 7:19 to go, first half. Thank you, Tim. Third down, Tennessee with a four-point lead midway through the second quarter, and Clawson 8 of 9 throwing the ball so far.
Casey's looking for a matchup right now, where he's got the best shot. Two safeties deep for Alabama to help.
Clawson skips into the secondary, flag is down, and so is Clawson, and this one might come back.
It's going to come back, but I'm really impressed with the poise of Casey Clawson right now, because that was an excellent decision. The play was called anticipating man coverage, and Alabama was going to play zone with two safeties to help, and Casey made a great decision to run, because it was not going to be open what they had called. He's thinking man-to-man, it's not there. He sees the middle open up and he runs for the first down. He's not a very gifted runner, but he knows where the first down was.
Well, that wipes out the first down. Clawson, as we mentioned, the sophomore, made his first start, came on in place of a struggling A.J. Suggs last year in this game. So a year ago this weekend, he's 9-2 as a starter. Yeah.
7-1 in the SEC. And he is getting better and better each week. Kelly Washington in the ball game down here at the bottom now against Herschel Bolden.
Dixon lays off the receiver top of the screen. So does Roberto McBride. Here's Clawson back. Stunts by Kendall Moorhead, and this one's going nowhere. Going nowhere. Victor Ellis, another of the Tennessee seniors, native of Chattanooga.
Well, you know, that's exciting for him to make a play. The screen pass is the play. They're going to Fleming, and here's Victor Ellis right here. Watch him read the screen. He's got man-to-man on Fleming, so he is right there to make the play. The screen pass was the play that gave them the lead over Georgia late in that ball game 2 weeks ago. Alabama ready for it there.
First punt, Dustin Colquitt. He has not had a good season, and he had a particularly ineffective game against Georgia, but this one, a very nice punt, deep. And Antonio Carter makes the tackle. Here's Colquitt, freshman, had a net on 8 punts of 22 yards in the loss to Georgia 2 weeks ago. 6:23 to go, first half. ...14-10 Tennessee over Alabama with 6:23 to go before the halftime break, and a first down 10 Crimson Tide, Tyler Watts. And the average on first down has gone up, but yeah, still not gaudy by any means.
Important right now for Tyler Watts to be smart with the football. They've played themselves back into the game. The worst thing they can do right now is have a turnover in their own end. Play clock down. Nope, didn't get it off. Nope. Now that's inexcusable, Vern. It really is.
I mean,
it was a timeout. You come off the field. You've got the play called. You just can't do that.
Four penalties now on Alabama.
I mean, this is simply a case where Tyler Watts, he's got to be aware of that. That's on him. It's not on the coach. It's not on anyone else. It's on Tyler Watts. If it's running down, speed up your snap count or call timeout, but don't give away 5 yards like that.
Now, this has been an off-penalized Alabama team. 55 coming in, so 59 for the season now in this 6.5 games. Beard is the deep back. He gets the handoff. And Santonio Beard breaks a tackle, breaks another, and punches it out to the 25-yard line. That's a gain of 11. A reminder that tomorrow at noon Eastern, it's the NFL Today on CBS. Jim Nantz and the gang for all the latest news and information. Leslie Visser has an exclusive interview with Patriot wide receiver Terry Glenn. Deion Sanders travels to Tampa Bay. The Bucs struggling to stay afloat, meet preseason expectations. Now, who's going to be quiet and listen to that conversation? Deion and Keyshawn. Second down. Second and four. Backs in the eye. Here's the option. The pitch back. Santonio Beard. He gets a block from Donnie Lau. Out of bounds with 5:33 to go. A gain of 14.
You mentioned the block by Donnie Lau, but also a great block by the backup tackle, Atlas Harrion, number 75. Watch this block here by the tackle on the side of the play. He gets engaged with Eddie Moore, and he won't let go. He just keeps riding him out. Then he turns him over to Lau, and Beard picks up the first down. Excellent block on the outside. Freddie Millen's also with a block on the cornerback.
5:33 to go before the break. Backs in the eye on first and 10. Beard's picked up 51 yards. Here's the give to the fullback, Donnie Lau, and there is nothing there. Junior from Laverne, Tennessee. Well, we asked the Aflac question, and here is the answer. Aside from Tennessee, the only other team to defeat Alabama six straight games, and it is Sewanee University, now called the University of the South, and they did so from 1896 to 1911. They're now a Division III school playing as the University of South in Sewanee. Second and 10. You knew that.
I did not.
You knew that one before we put it up. Here's Weiss. In and out of the hands. A little high.
It's been high a lot, Vern. You know, he made the great throw to Sam Collins for the touchdown, but that's about the third or fourth throw that he's made too high. And it's not because of pressure. He's just got to kind of get his feet set and make a better throw. Again, I think both quarterbacks to this point have done what they need to do to give their team a chance to win. Tyler Watts is making some plays throwing the football, but those easy ones like that, you got to take those. I mean, you got to be able to capitalize on those.
And Tyler Watts will use a timeout. Stops the clock with 4 minutes and 51 seconds to go before the break. When we come back, Alabama third and 10. .451 to go first half, third and 10, Alabama trailing by four.
And they really have to be careful here, Vern. I mean, they're 3 for 5 on third down. Tyler Watts can't force the issue here. If he's got it, take it. If not, punt the football and try to play defense here the rest of the half.
Little half roll to the left. He finds Galloway one-on-one, and Galloway avoids the first tackle, but then is stopped short of the first down by Eddie Moore, number 37.
But again, Vern, the pass was high, and the reason that Galloway couldn't catch it and take off right away is because he had to jump for the football. If Galloway can catch this on the ground with his feet on the ground, he can maybe turn upfield and get the first down, but he had to jump first to catch it, and by that time, Eddie Moore able to catch up to him.
Now, Eric Parker back to return the Lane Bearden punt on fourth down and 5. Pressure coming. Bearden does get rid of it.
Wow. Great kick.
And it takes a Tennessee bounce, goes into the end zone, and will come out to the 20. With pressure, Jabari Greer, number 33, was one of a trio of defenders who almost got to Lane Bearden. 55-yard punt, nothing on the return.
Well, Alabama got close to the last Tennessee punt, and this time Tennessee very close. Three guys actually in a position to sell out and try to make the block, and nobody gets a piece of the football.
With 4:03 to go first half, Tennessee gets it back. They're nursing a 4-point lead. Travis Stevens with a 60-yard touchdown run, the difference in the ballgame right now. Here's Clawson, right side. Caught by Will Bartholomew, and a nice, very nice open field tackle by Wayne Bacon, a former walk-on who was awarded a scholarship by Dennis Franchione earlier this year.
You know, the smart thing he did here, Vern, is he took on a bigger man by going low. A lot of times, if you try to tackle a bigger player up high, you miss that tackle. He goes low, he wraps the arms around the legs, and he won't let go. It's a nice open field tackle by Bacon.
Bartholomew with his second catch in the game, but this one for no gain. It's second. Well, they're going to give him a yard. Make it second down and 9. Now Clawson's got 2 receivers split left and another wide right. 4-man Alabama rush. Clawson caught and dropped. Kendall Moorhead, face mask.
Yeah. Boy, they finally got to him. Kendall Moorhead finally got to the quarterback. But he got a hold of the face mask. Watch him work on the outside. He beats Ofenhuizel easily. And gets the sack, but also gets the penalty, and it'll probably be a 15-yarder.
Now it's indication of holding against Tennessee. Now that was the official indication from Steve, the preliminary indication rather, from here's the call.
We'll let them sort it out.
Yes.
Holding by the offense. Penalty refused. Third down.
The hold was on the other side, Vern. Reggie Coleman working on Todd Bates, the true freshman. Here's where the hold is going to occur, and then the sack's going to occur from this side. Todd Bates, good quick pass rusher, taken down by Coleman. Had his hands around him, and Moorhead gets credit for the sack.
Third and 13. And a conversation taking place between the officiating crew down on the field.
And you know, we should clarify too that Kendall Moorhead didn't grab the face mask. The way that Clawson went down, it appeared that he did, but he actually kind of got him around the neck and whipped him down that way.
I'm not so sure Clawson would agree with that. Tim Brando, Spencer Tillman at halftime. We're 3 minutes away. Third and 13. That's Witten in motion. Here's Clawson. Looks deep, settles short. Witten, cocked down. Victor Ellis.
Vern, you already said he's from Chattanooga. He played at Red Bank High School, and the 6'2", 240-pound senior has made a couple big plays for this Alabama defense today. Man-to-man responsibility on the tight end Witten and the good open field tackle.
Nice moment for Victor Ellis, who actually, as a senior, lost his starting position to Cornelius Wortham after the Arkansas game 3 weeks ago, playing well today. Here's Colquitt. He nails this one. Antonio Carter has it at the 36.
Wow.
And somebody lost a helmet. It was Carter, and he is down. No, it was not Carter. It was Houston.
What great coverage, though, by Tennessee. Stephen Marsh, a backup defensive tackle or defensive back. Watch how quickly he's down there and makes the great open field tackle. Now here's the helmet flying, but it was already a nice tackle made by Stephen Marsh. Nice coverage. Left side tackle, right side helmet.
First and 10 Alabama, down by 4 with 2:07 to go. They've got 2 timeouts remaining. Here's Watts with the reverse, Freddie Millins. Good job by Alabama of sniffing it out. Fine pursuit, though Millins does get the first down.
Excellent execution. The fake was carried out very well by Galloway and Watts, and they fooled him. Watts Galloway sell the fake like he's got the ball. He's running hard up through the defense. That freezes the Tennessee defense, and they caught him running one way and the reverse out the other side. When you get in a late 2-minute situation, if you get a big play right away, now you start thinking about scoring. They're out at the 50-yard line.
13-yard gain for Millins on first down and 10. Here's the option and the pitch. And it's Galloway, nothing doing.
Nice defense by Tennessee. Kevin Burnett, a very speedy young linebacker out of Carson, California.
Julian Battle, a JC transfer. Burnett. John Chavis telling us in a conversation earlier this week, he thinks he's going to be the next outstanding Tennessee linebacker.
Yeah, missed almost all of summer camp. Coming back from an injury.
Second and 9. Lau is the fullback. Play fake. Watts nailed. Rush came from the corner. And Jabari Greer on the blitz got there.
play action pass against this kind of a blitz. Here's the blitz. Now, I think the tailback has to take him. The tailback, Santonio Beard, he has to give up the fake and block that blitzer. And I don't think Santonio Beard saw the blitz coming from the outside, and the quarterback paid the price for it.
Tennessee leads it 14-10, less than a minute to go. Alabama looks at third and 17 with one timeout left. And a reminder that toward the end of this game, we will be selecting the Army Most Valuable Player of the game. That's 30 minutes of football action away. Tyler Watts out of the spread. Santonio Beard to his left. That's Terry Jones, the motion man. Four-man rush. Watts. They came from the corner and got him again. Beard tried to get back for the block. Could not get there in time. Andre Lott, the senior from Memphis.
And Tennessee takes a quick timeout. Back-to-back defensive plays by Tennessee that send Alabama going backwards. Now they have to punt.
Recall that Alabama will have to punt. Tennessee used two timeouts earlier. They've got one left, 39 seconds. Out of timeouts, beg your pardon. There's the punt. Rashad Baker at the 14-yard line. And he has stopped across the 20 after the 23 with 25 seconds to go. Now, we've talked about turnarounds in this series, and of course, back in the 1997 SEC Championship game, it took place on December 6th at the Georgia Dome in Atlanta. The Volunteers faced Terry Bowden and the Tigers from Auburn. Peyton Manning threw four touchdown passes, including a 73-yard pass to Marcus Nash in the fourth quarter as Tennessee held on for a close 30-29 victory in an epic contest. And there's what appears to be the final play of the first quarter, and a reminder, of course, that we are pleased to be able to televise the championship game this year. Saturday night, December 8th, from the Georgia Dome in Atlanta. And these guys among the contenders to be there, Tennessee. Georgia won big today, coming from behind to knock off Kentucky. And we've reached the halftime break in Tuscaloosa. Little conversation with Dennis Franchione and Steve Landis, and we go down to Jill Arrington.
Coach Casey Clawson's playing real solid for you. Is he doing what you think he needs to do to get this offense to a victory?
Casey's played really well so far. I think we've had a nice balance. There's a play or two out there that we could have made that we hadn't made, but you know, the biggest concern, we got to get to the passer a little bit better in the second half. We can't play that kind of man coverage and not get to the quarterback. So I think we'll be all right. We just got to play better, a little bit better defensively second half.
All right, Coach. Thanks a lot.
Phillip sounds a little hoarse, but he'll have an oration for his team at halftime, I'll bet. 14-10. We go back to New York. Here's Tim Brendo. Welcome back to Bryant-Denny Stadium on the campus of the University of Alabama in Tuscaloosa. We get set for the start of the second half. 14-10, Tennessee with the lead. And the Alabama Crimson Tide will receive the kickoff to open the third quarter. Freddie Millens, the deep man of two. He's joined back there by Antonio Carter. AC with a 45-yard catch to set up the only Alabama touchdown.
And that was it. One catch for him, one catch for Freddie Millens, a 7-yarder in the opening series for Alabama. And those two guys, very much two of the playmakers for Alabama. It'll be important for them to play big in this second half.
Alex Walls will kick off for the Tennessee Volunteers, trying to win for the seventh consecutive year against the Crimson Tide in this 84th meeting and the second in 3 years in Tuscaloosa. Millens, near side at the four. And down at the 19-yard line. As we get set for the start of the third quarter, 14-10, and Travis Stevens with the 60-yard run. What do you think about the tempo play so far?
Well, I think it's been a very well-played game, Vern. I think both teams have done what they needed to do offensively and defensively. And interesting, not a turnover in the first half, not a breakdown in the kicking game. One of those two things could be the difference here in the second half. And when Tennessee has the ball, we mentioned Millens. I think Kelly Washington, a big mystery right now, too. They're number 15, zero catches in that first half.
Terry Jones starts in motion, now goes back on first down and 10. Here's the handoff. It goes to Santonio Beard, the freshman running back, who is seeing a lot of action in this game. And let's break it down statistically for you. At the break, the end of the first half, Todd mentioned no turnovers by either team thus far.
And you see the rushing yards highlighted. Coming into the game, Alabama number one in the conference in rushing, Tennessee number two. Alabama's numbers not great, but already more yards than Tennessee has given up per game coming into today's ball game.
High formation on second down. Option play, Watts with a pitch, Beard, he gets a kick out block from Donnie Lau. And is tackled at the 27-yard line. Tackle made by Keon Whiteside. Once again, let's go back to New York. And here's Tim Brando.
Alabama knows all about Auburn, Vern. And now Auburn's finding out. Luke McCown, who's thrown for 381 yards today, 23 yards to Delwin Daigle. He does get into the end zone. This ties the game. Auburn is trying to get Damon Duvall in position for a winning field goal with 24 seconds left.
Wow. How many times can they go to the well?
Well, if he kicks it, it'll be the fourth straight game for Damon Duvall. Here's a pass deep side. Millens got it. Still loose. Still loose. Now he's not.
You know what, Vern? I don't even know how Tyler Watts got this off. I thought he was going to get sacked. He's able to elude pressure and then find Millens. He beat Julian Battle. Look at the separation Millens got. And right away, Dennis Franchione gets the ball to his playmaker Millens. I mentioned he had one catch in the first half early. How does Watts get away from the pressure? Albert Haynesworth is there, a couple guys unblocked, and Watts steps up in the pocket and delivers a strike.
That is a gain of 39 yards, the catch by Freddie Millens, and a first down, Alabama. Handoff, nope, keeper. Watts with a fake to Santonio Beard, and then he cut to his left inside the 30. Jabari Greer with the tackle for Tennessee.
This is worth one more look by Tyler Watts. He gets away from Haynesworth, steps up. Dominique Stevens coming right in his face. And that is excellent work and concentration by Tyler Watts.
Second down and six at the 29. Freddie Millens with his second catch of the game. Ahmad Galloway is in the lineup again. He's the deep back now. Two wide receivers split left. Play fake. Watts looks deep for his tight end. Jones goes, no, he'll keep it. Backside hit, and he's down at the 28-yard line. All of that for a gain of one.
He's lucky he didn't fumble that, Vern, because he had no idea that Bernard Jackson was coming at him from behind. He makes a nice decision to run, and he makes a good move on the man in front of him, but has no idea there's a guy behind him. You see him carrying the ball in the right hand. Very lucky that Jackson doesn't strip that out.
Third and four, 14-10. Three wide receivers, four wides now on the field. Three left and one right.
Alabama 3 of 7 on third downs in that first half.
Tennessee blitzing. Option comes to the near side. Watts. Inside the 20, first and 10, Alabama.
Here's the big difference in that third down play. In the first half, they were 3 of 7, and they averaged the needed yardage with over 8 yards per third down play. This was third and four, so the option is very much a viable opportunity. Third and four, Tyler Watts runs the option. The defense says keep it, and he gets the first down. Gets a nice block from his tackle, Evan Mathis, and the Alabama keeps the ball.
Rashad Moore injured for the second time in the ball game, so he'll get some assistance on the Tennessee bench. First and 10, Alabama. Opening drive of the third quarter, they trail by four. There's Brandon Greer, number 81, in motion, and Watts keeps it. Interesting. You talk to the assistant coaches during the week, and you go through what they call the three deep. Anybody who's going to play here? Is there anybody on your roster who will not, who's not listed, who will play in the game? Nope. Well, Brandon Greer is nowhere to be found on the three deep. But that's the second play in which he's been involved so far. Second and seven. I formation, Lau and Beard. Straight up the middle, Beard. That will be first and goal, Alabama.
Nice push on the inside. They've been getting outside on the perimeter with the option. Watch the inside blocking right here. The center, Ephraim, drives his man completely out of the hole, then a missed tackle by the linebacker Dominique Stevenson. And Santonio Beard, now seven carries for 68 yards. Playing against his home state team and making the most of the opportunity today.
First and goal, Alabama down by four. He darts to the right, cuts it up inside the right tackle, and is tackled himself at the six-yard line.
One of the things I felt at the end of the first half, in the last five, 6 minutes, I thought that Alabama was turning it up a notch in terms of coming off the ball and taking control of the line of scrimmage, particularly their defensive front. So far here to start the third quarter, Alabama's offensive line turning it up a notch as well. They're taking it right at Tennessee right now, running the football.
Second and goal from the seven. Sam Collins in motion, wide to the left. Play fake. Watts got a man. Collins, touchdown!
Vern, I guarantee you Tyler Watts was throwing this ball away. He was not throwing this to complete a touchdown. It was well defended by Teddy Gaines. There is a flag down. Watch Tyler Watts. He comes out of the play fake. He doesn't see what he likes. He thinks run. No, just throw it away and don't take a sack. And Collins, again, adjusts to the football. He's not open there. He drifts. And again, I think Tyler Watts is trying to throw that out of the end zone to avoid the sack. He comes away with a touchdown.
Well, there is a continuing discussion about the flag, but I believe the flag has been picked up. We've had no explanation yet from Steve Landis.
You know that old saying, sometimes it's better to be lucky than good?
Yep.
Tyler Watts
was dead. Unsportsmanlike conduct on the defense. Touchdown is good. Penalty will be enforced on the extra point.
Boy, oh boy.
Neil Thomas with the extra point. It appeared the penalty might have been called on Amari Hand for a late hit. There's Thomas's extra point up and good. Sam Collins, first touchdown of his career last week. He's doubled that today. Alabama by three. Pause for celebration for Big Al. Whoops. Alabama leads it by three. Lane Bearden will kick off for the Crimson Tide. An 80-yard drive. The touchdown, Sam Collins, 6 yards out. Tinsley and Scott, the two deep men now for the Volunteers. Leonard Scott takes it at the three. Got a little room. Knocked down as he gets near the 30-yard line.
As the kicker.
By the kicker, Lane Bearden. Well, let's go back and look at that touchdown catch by Sam Collins.
Well, two times today we've seen Sam Collins adjust to his quarterback who's under duress. He's not open on the little out route, but he sees his quarterback just try to get rid of it, and he adjusts to the football and comes down with the touchdown catch. Collins is a guy who four career records, receiving records, he broke in his high school. Mom, dad, and his brother all attended Alabama, and he is definitely going today.
First down and 10, flag.
Vern, I'm going to tell you what's happened in this game now. I made the point in the last 5 minutes or so of the first half, the Alabama defense turned it up a notch. They got more physical. In the first few minutes of this half.
False start by the offense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
In the first few minutes of this half, the Alabama offense has gotten more physical. And what that's done is it has kind of sent a shockwave through this crowd and got them electric and back into the ballgame.
Clawson now with the Volunteers, first down and 15. That's Bobby Graham, number 11, in motion. And here's Clawson. Gets a block from Fred Weary on Kendall Moorhead. That allows him to turn the corner and get five back. And do we have a hit?
Yep.
We do. Late hit on Brooks Daniels.
Well, we've seen a couple unnecessary penalties. This was unnecessary by Alabama. Good defense, forced the quarterback to run out of bounds. Just don't need to take that extra shot.
Daniels, the sophomore from Jasper, Florida. And here's the indication.
After the ball was dead, it was a personal foul against the defense. That's a 15-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
Carl Torbush, former head coach at North Carolina in his first year.
Can't be pleased with that. I mean, Casey Clawson is having a nice ball game. Don't give him any help. He's 11 of 12 for 103 yards and a touchdown. You force him out of the pocket, don't hit him late.
First down and 10. Again, Kelly Washington remains on the bench. Here's Clawson rolling out with a lot of room. Fires it out, incomplete. Just to go back to the story of the 22-year-old freshman who played minor league baseball for 4 years, Kelly Washington with an almost unbelievable performance. 11 catches against LSU, 236 yards. Came back and had a big game against Georgia, but is bothered by a sore foot, we are told, and did not practice this week.
It's the beginning of a stress fracture in his left foot. You see 29 catches, clearly the leading receiver. They played almost the whole year without Dante Stallworth. Now they got him back, but Washington a non-factor today.
Stevens and Bartholomew in the eye. And this will be Travis Stevens. Nothing there. Third down. And for more on Kelly Washington, let's check in once again with Jill Arrington.
Well, as you see, he's heading out on the field right now. They have told me it is not a medical decision that he is out of the game. He just hasn't gotten in there to get too many touches, but they're looking to get him in this half, so let's see what he does.
But, Jill, that's ridiculous. I mean, if he's healthy and if he can play, why not throw the football at him? I mean, he's been spectacular the whole season, and they've played 30 minutes and haven't thrown the ball at him one time. That makes no sense to me.
Gerald Dixon is defending him, and he comes up to play a little bump and run. Top of the screen. Blitz, Clawson, Dante Stallworth. No flag, incidental conduct. It'll be fourth down.
Nice play by Charles Jones, and this is a free safety having to play man-to-man coverage. They're going to the slot. It's a blitz, so that puts a safety in man coverage. Got away with a little contact. But still good position by Charles Jones, the sophomore out of Waynesboro, Georgia.
On fourth down, Dustin Colquitt will kick it away to Antonio Carter. Millens and Carter sharing that punt return duty. Here's Colquitt, nice and high, but fairly short. And Carter, no, boy. Hearts aflutter throughout Tuscaloosa.
There hasn't been a turnover yet, and there hasn't been a breakdown in the kicking game. We almost had both in one play.
17-14 with 8 minutes and 18 seconds remaining. Third quarter. 8 minutes and 18 seconds remaining. Third quarter from Tuscaloosa. Bryant-Denny Stadium, more than 80,000 on a splendid third Saturday in October, the 84th meeting. Between these interstate rivals, a large contingent of Tennessee fans having made their way south from Knoxville, and they find themselves trailing by three. Watts goes deep right side for Millens, man coverage, and a double comes over. He makes the catch and is down. No, now they're going to say incomplete.
Heck of an effort, though, Vern. I mean, this was not a very well-thrown ball by Tyler Watts. But as you see so often, the offensive guy is the aggressor. He finds the football before Andre Lott does, adjusts to it. And that very, I'll tell you what, Vern, I think this is a catch. And I think it's a fumble.
Yes, sir.
I don't think, you know, actually Alabama's probably lucky because that should have been a catch and a fumble.
It is called incomplete, second down and 10. Option, left side, pitch back, Santonio Beard. Came into this game with 163 yards for the season, and he's gotten more than a quarter of that total here in this ball game. Midway through the third quarter. Let's take another look at this catch or no catch by Freddie Mullins.
Well, it's ruled an incompletion, but it looks to me like he had possession of the ball before he went to the ground. Close call to make, and as it turns out, a good call for Alabama.
I will say this, if this were, as some folks refer to it, the next level, we'd be in the midst of about a 12-minute delay right now. Third and 9. Right side, that one sailed and is high again. It's happened to him a multitude of times today. 17-14 here. Let's find out what's happening with Auburn. Here's Timmy B.
Well, Damon Duval had his chance and missed it from 37 yards in regulation. But in overtime, Daniel Cobb to DeAndre Green, 48-41 over Louisiana Tech. Congratulations to Jack McNeil III, who was the center for Boston College on the Hale Foolie play.
That's a nice note.
Yeah. Wouldn't have anything to do with the fact that the Louisiana team, would it? Timmy B throwing out those kudos.
Here's the punt. Lane Bearden. And it is taken by Eric Parker. Nailed. Good downfield coverage. Theo Sanders, number 89, a 40-yard punt and 2 on the return. 7:19 to go. Third quarter of play. Crimson Tide lead the Volunteers. Third quarter. And Smokey hoping the Volunteers can come from behind. On first down and 10, Clawson hands it off to Stevens. He breaks into the secondary again. He's really quick at the line of scrimmage. And moves it out to the 46-yard line. That's a gain of 8. Now let's take a look at the SEC moment presented by Sonic. The 1951 game, 50 years ago today, between Alabama and Tennessee, Legion Field, Birmingham. This was the first ever televised SEC game. It was televised by WAPI Television in Birmingham. The play-by-play man, Maury Farrell. Bobby Marlowe of Alabama had a 1-yard touchdown run. Tennessee won the contest 27-13. Second down. Stevens. First down, Tennessee, across the 50 to the 47. Well, one of us in this booth remembers 1951. 50 years ago today. I don't remember watching that telecast, but what else was happening? Well, the best actor was Humphrey Bogart, best picture American in Paris. Go down to the bottom. How about a new car? 1800. Gas was 20 cents a gallon. The average income, though, was $3,500. First down and 10.
Tennessee answering that, taking it up a notch physically. Third carry in a row for Travis Stevens.
Gets by Wayne Bacon. Bacon rides him down, but out of bounds. That's a gain of 7. Let's go once again back to the pride of Shreveport. Here's Tim Brando.
Thanks, Vern. Well, Jeff Sagarin had him ranked 15th in the country. They had won 12 in a row, but Toledo's Tavares Bolden has picked off Quentin Manley of Ball State. Pitched the game away. That's right, and the fans went wild at David Letterman Stadium. It'll cost quite a bit. $10,000. I'm sure that alum can take care of that. Back to Vern.
Yeah, he'll love you mentioning that. Second down. 6:10 to go, third quarter. Backs in the eye. Again, they give it to Stevens. And Salim Rashid has to fight off a block to come out and turn him inside. But Tennessee running well now. Another gain of 8 yards.
You know, the one thing you see about Travis Stevens, Vern, is when Tennessee needs a play, that's who they're going to. I mean, again, this is his first year as the feature back. Now 18 carries for 132 yards and a touchdown. And look at the average per carry. That's outstanding against a very good front seven in Alabama.
Kelly Washington, top of your screen. They've not thrown to him yet in the ball game. Gerald Dixon backs off. They'll keep it on the ground to Stevens, who is hit behind the line by Kenny King. And that slows him up. He does get to the 31-yard line. Now the rushing leaders in a single season. And look at the projected figure for Travis Stevens. Averaging, as we said, 147 yards per game through the first four for Tennessee, and approaching that number today.
He's also on pace to break Reggie Cobb's all-purpose yards record set in 1987 of 1,721 yards. Best way to slow him down now is rip his shoe off, make him go to the sideline.
Troy Fleming is the setback. Clausen, blitz, Rashid coming. They go left side for Jason Witten. He makes the catch at the 30-yard line. It'll be third down.
This is a little combination that a lot of teams use. The outside receiver runs a post route, and the inside receiver, Witten, runs a little flat route. You read it? That's a heck of a catch by a big man. Tight end, Jason Witten, 6'5". Shows some soft hands on that one.
13 catches by the two tight ends, Finlayson and Witten, for the year. Third and eight. Leonard Scott goes wide right. Graham also in the slot, and Washington wide left. Now they throw it to Kelly Washington. Diving try at the 25.
One of the few bad throws that Casey Clawson has made. I think he thought that he was going to get pressure quicker. Watch this now. He takes the shotgun snap. It gets into his stomach, and he just rushes the throw. Doesn't get his feet in the right position. He's been very accurate today, but he didn't give his receiver a chance to make the catch and run on that one.
Comes up short of the first down. It'll be fourth and two, and Alex Walls, a junior from Bristol, Virginia, on. Seth Reagan will hold it. Dan Stacy snaps it. This from 42 yards out for the tie. No. Wide left.
Two weeks ago when they lost to Georgia, Alex Walls had a big miss right at the end of the first half that would have put him up 20-17. How big is this kick going to be when this one's all said and done? Could have tied the game at 17. You had a nice offensive drive. And now you still trail by three.
Ball goes over, first and 10, Alabama. They're up 17-14. Out of the spread, Tyler Watts. He still got it, looks for Millens, lobs it short over the head of Terry Jones, the tight end. Well, the pictures from 3,000 feet above Bryant-Denny Stadium, brought to you by the Saturn Lightship. This 165-foot dirigible is the newest airship in the world. By the way, some of you might be wondering about our ability to bring you pictures from the blimp. The FAA has loosened restrictions on blimps over stadiums as long as they stay 3,000 feet above the facility. And we welcome the pictures from up on top back to Saturn Venus. Here's Watts. Goes deep left side. Gray Folgum, number three, who has only one catch this season, and that one overthrown in the middle of double coverage. Now Watts for the day, 8 of 16 for 157. Clawson at the break had 11 of 12. Modest yardage figures. Yeah. Matter of fact, Watts has one third of that on one catch.
Yeah. Two touchdowns. Again, I think both quarterbacks have made plays, and it's still going to come down to that as we get into the fourth quarter.
Third and 10, three-man front for Tennessee. They drop eight. There's Jason McCadley. He's another of those Tennessee natives. He grew up in Oak Ridge, Tennessee, only 10 minutes from the campus. He told us the other day, he said they forced him to learn Rocky Top when he was in elementary school. I hate Rocky Top. McCadley, who has yet to earn a victory. That's Kenneth Pope, the receiver coach, who's on crutches. Fell and pulled a tendon earlier in the week. Here's the snapback to Lane Bearden. No rush this time. Eric Parker, good punt. At the 21, Rashid chases him. Oh, nice open field play. Chris James, number 32. That was terrific. And Chatu Ray also down there.
Good coverage by Alabama. Rasheed forces him outside. They maintain their position, and Chatu Ray, who's probably the best special teams player on the Alabama team, there to wrap up Parker.
And Chris James came over and got him a picture.
32, 33, whatever.
33, yeah, you know, we're within one. Tennessee is within three. Bobby Graham in motion. Blitz, right side, little quick screen. Washington all the way out near midfield. He's such a big target. Yeah.
And see, that's the thing. He can take a short pass, and he's so physical at 6'4", 225 pounds, that he can just whip a smaller corner. Now, too much cushion out there by Gerald Dixon. I mean, he's nowhere to be seen around Kelly Washington. And Kelly Washington shows he can break tackles. And again, if his foot's okay, I throw it to him as many times as he can stay in the game for right now.
Well, he comes near side against Herschel Bolden, who backs off, and then Naughton McKay Losher, number 90, came across the neutral zone.
I think Casey Clawson thought that he was going to get an offsides penalty here, and they snapped it quick. Now, whether or not there was movement across the zone, we'll find out.
Offsides on the defense. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
There's the movement right there by David Daniel. And Casey Clawson gets a gift 5 yards.
First down and five at the 46. David Daniel wearing number 57. Casey Clawson, 14 of 17 now, 134 yards. Deep left side for Washington, Herschel Bolden. Tipped away by Bolden, number 25.
Nice play by Herschel Bolden. He didn't let the guy out-muscle him. Again, Herschel Bolden, 6 foot 195 against 6'4", 225. But watch Herschel find the ball and not let him get pushed out of the way. He matches strength with Kelly Washington and knocks the pass away. That's a good play by Herschel Bolden.
Gives Casey Clawson and the Volunteers a second down and five. 2:25 to go, 2:26 officially in the third quarter. Troy Fleming is the only setback now. This is Whitten in motion. And again, Alabama football. Clawson down. Scramble for the ball at the 50.
I think Alabama's going to get this one. Casey Clawson could never find the football. He tried to pull out and make the pitch before he had control, and it got tangled up around his feet, and he couldn't find it.
This looks very much like a game being played in New Zealand right
now.
Wow.
Tennessee gets it back.
Yep.
That was a definite fight under the pile. But take a look at this. It looks like Fred Weary is going to pull from his left guard position and knock the ball. You see his right hand. Fred Weary knocked the ball out of Casey Clawson's hands, and Tennessee very lucky to get this back. But you know what, Vern? As a quarterback, you have to put that ball in your stomach. You can't let that ball hanging out there for just that reason. They call that seeding the football. You take the snap and it goes right into your belly, so you avoid any kind of a problem like that. Tennessee very lucky there.
Third and nine at the 50, and Clawson will go from the spread.
A lot of room for Kelly Washington out wide to the bottom of the screen. Man coverage way off.
Bolden is 15 yards back. Clawson across the middle, caught by Stallworth, avoids a tackle and is hit from behind, but it's a first down at the 21-yard line after the 29-yard game.
Boy, just too much room given up by the Alabama secondary on this one. Washington was open. Here's Stallworth working against zone coverage. He finds the hole. Chatu Ray goes for the interception of the knockdown, and Dante Stallworth turns it into a bigger play. Good protection. Nice, accurate throw by Clawson. And you see Stallworth again playing with that cast on the left wrist, able to make the soft catch.
Back in the lineup after sitting out the last three games, played in the season opener against Syracuse. Five catches today. Clawson. Oh, wide open. Whitten at the goal line. Touchdown to the tight end.
Yeah. This is a great job by Casey Clawson using his eyes. The more a guy plays, the better he gets at doing stuff like this. Witten's going to run the post, but watch Casey Clawson look off the safety to the left. He looks him left, he keeps him where he wants him, and then throws back to the other side for the touchdown. If Casey Clawson stares down his receiver, there's no way he makes this play. He looks Charles Jones for a little bit and then throws it back to the tight end for the touchdown.
Here's the extra point, up and good. He is a big target. Jason Witten, 6'5", 265 yards. And the sophomore from Elizabethton, Tennessee, has his first touchdown catch of the year. 21-17, Tennessee comes from behind and reclaims the lead. We are live at Bryant-Denny Stadium on the campus of the University of Alabama. 1:16 to go, third quarter. Vern Lundquist, Todd Blackledge, along with Jill Arrington. And the Volunteers ranked 11th in the country. A 21-yard touchdown reception, first of his career. Jason Witten off the arm of Casey Clawson.
What a great response and an answer by the Tennessee offense. And now the onus on the Alabama offense. 2-3 and out, their last two possessions. They must do something here.
Wall sails this one into the end zone and out to the left. Touchback. Thursday on CBS, Survivor is back and better than ever. Don't miss an all-new episode when the baby boomers take on Generation X and hungry lions are on the prowl. That's Survivor Africa Thursday on CBS. Tyler Watts, the junior from Pelham, Alabama. 9 rushing yards. The option has been well defensed today by this Tennessee team. From the 20, first and 10. They give it off to Santonio Beard. He gets a block. He's got one man to beat, and he's got McCadley downfield to try and supply the block. Here's Beard. And he tries a little huck and buck at the 11-yard line.
He got tired, Vern. I mean, he got enough of a block from Jason McCadley, but he got tired. And look, he's saying, I need a break right now. I need some water. But what a run, and what a nice block by the fullback, Downey Lau. He's the guy who got the key block on Robert Peace. Alonzo Ephraim with the block. And Santonio Beard. He's having an outstanding game. Just doesn't have quite enough gas to take it to the end zone on this one.
69-yard rumble. He's got 141 yards on 10 carries. A first down just outside the 10. Golfway, Galloway, up the middle to the 4.
Nice call. Nice call by Les Koenig. Get back to being physical. Get back to going right at him. John Chavis' defense had forced 2-3 and outs the last two Alabama possessions. And right now, they're on their heels a little bit.
Second down and 3 at the 4. Millens breaks and goes wide to the left side.
They can get a first down without scoring a touchdown here, too, right about the 1-yard line.
There's Watts with the automatic at the line of scrimmage. Option left, pitch back to Galloway. Lau with the ball, touchdown Alabama. Donnie Lau with a huge block.
If you want to run this, you've got to have a block by your fullback, and he gets another good one. Donnie Lau, the decision to pitch is good. The block by Lau on the linebacker, Kevin Burnett, and Galloway knows where the end zone is.
Neil Thomas for the extra point. Jonathan Ritchie with a hole. And a quick answer by the Alabama Crimson Tide. The touchdown by the junior Galloway, but set up on a 69-yard run from Santonio Beard. That's the end of 3. We'll return to Tuscaloosa right after this message and a word from your local station. We've got something brewing in the capstone. 24-21 Alabama trying to erase 6 losses in a row to the Tennessee Volunteers. They have reclaimed the lead. Here is Lane Bearden. taken by Scott near the goal line. Leonard Scott, hurdle, flag down. Two flags are down. This one will come back as Scott brings it all the way out to the 33, but the penalty no doubt will go against the Volunteers of Tennessee. And a 69-yard run by the freshman Santonio Beard provided the impetus for the go-ahead touchdown. And Galloway got it with a kickout block from Donnie Lau to put Alabama back on top. 24-21, we get set for the start of the final quarter. Vern Lundquist, Todd Blackledge. I got a feeling, though, given what's happened to Alabama in the last two SEC games,
yeah,
fans are going
nervous,
like us.
The
yeah.
Fourth quarter. I mean, they have not been able to finish the deal in a couple of losses. They've lost three games, and they've been outplayed in the fourth quarter all three. Now, against South Carolina, you see they had a 12-point lead with 9 minutes left. They lost by one. Totally dominated. Last week against Ole Miss, they didn't make a first down. They punted four times, and they blew that lead to lose again. Tennessee also. They played poorly in the fourth quarter against LSU, but hung on to win. And then against Georgia 2 weeks ago, they got outplayed in the fourth quarter as well. So both teams need to prove that they can play in the fourth quarter.
After the penalty, Tennessee starts from inside the 15. Here's Carson with a handoff up the middle. Stevens knocked down as he gets near the 19-yard line. Casey Clawson. You called him a cool Californian earlier, right?
He is. He is the Iceman. Remember the Iceman from the movie Top Gun? Striking similarities.
He's got a little Val Kilmer look, huh? Second and five.
I think he's hoping that Kelly Washington will prove to be his wingman again tonight.
Graham starts in motion. Here's Clawson handing it off to Stevens again. Nice defensive effort by Alabama. Well, Casey Clawson, in his freshman year, how about the comparison with Peyton Manning?
Yeah, pretty close. And you know what? The thing we got to mention as a disclaimer for Casey Clawson, he's been hampered by the injuries to his wide receiver. I mean, Dante Stallworth is just now back from the first week. Kelly Washington has been pretty much a non-factor in the ball game tonight. Eric Parker has been out until this week as well. So
third and four, Washington wide right on Thurman Ward. Here's Clawson across the middle, caught by his tight end, Witten. And he rumbles out across the 40 near the 45.
This is really good decisions by Randy Sanders and then Casey Clawson. They're anticipating double coverage on the outside receiver. See, they see safeties right here that are going to help on the wide receivers. That means tight end, single coverage, go against the single coverage. Excellent decision by Casey Clawson, finding the best matchup and getting the ball to his tight end, Witten.
Five receptions for 68 yards, including a touchdown for Jason Witten. First and 10, whistle.
Alabama had to take a timeout. They had 12 guys on the field. It was a late substitution by Carl Torbush, who is down on the field, by the way. He started the year up in the box. And in the last two games, he's been down on the field, I think, to just kind of improve the communication with his defense. That time, still a miscommunication. They had to call timeout.
Minutes, 9 seconds to go in this one. Alabama leads by three. First down and 10, Tennessee.
You know, Alabama defensively, they need a play from one of their leaders, Jarrett Johnson in the middle, number 96, playing with some injuries, but he's got to step up now for Alabama.
Here's Clawson, flushed out of the pocket, going right, hit and dropped. Naughton McKay Osher was the first man there. Salim Rashid also helped.
This is good defense, good pressure by Losher. He's right here. He's going to force the issue, beating the fullback Fleming. And then watch how quickly Rashid reacts. I mean, when he makes a read and he gets to the ball, he gets there in a hurry and usually in a bad mood.
Second down and 9, 24-21. Difference in the game is a field goal right now.
Looks like a checkoff here by Clawson.
Clawson Sets up across the middle for his tight end, Witten. And he struggles for another Tennessee first down. Tackle is made at the 43.5 yard line. Well, we're talking about field goals. Listen to, or take a look at this. Between quarters, this man's name is Charles Griffin. This is a 50-yard field goal. 50 yards between quarters. And he made $50,000. Now that's a pressure kick.
Yes, it was.
And boy, there was no question about it. Looked like Damon Duvall.
No question.
No question. First and 10. Pump, fake, right, Stallworth deep, overthrown, and incomplete at the goal line. Roberto McBride defending.
We've seen this a couple times where it looks like Casey maybe has thrown this ball a little too far inside. It's the stop and go for Stallworth. And you want to throw that ball away from the safety, but Stallworth just can't quite catch up to it. And again, he's really kind of playing with 1.5 hands. I mean, that's not two full hands that he's playing with. So anything that's kind of out of his reach is going to be tough for him to bring in. Watch for Witten again now. He's been the go-to guy. 6 catches for 80 yards. Here he is right here, the tight end.
Bobby Graham starts in motion, followed by Ward. They'll draw on the draw play, and Stevens caught after a gain of 1.5. This is going to bring up a third and long again. Well, let's update you on other SEC action today. Georgia comes from behind at home to defeat Kentucky. Overtime, Auburn, fresh from the upset of Florida, defeats La Tech. Ole Miss, Eli Manning, looks like he had another big day, 45-17 over a good Middle Tennessee team. Vanderbilt, South Carolina tonight. Third and 8.
Here's Witten over here on the left side of the formation, the tight end.
He gets loose, and there he is, but that's short of the front. Oh, look at him work. They had him caught short of the first down. And the 265-pounder pushed the pile by himself.
Pretty well defensed by Alabama. They stop him short. They think, okay, 3 guys, we should be able to get him on the ground and make him give up the football. But Witten just keeps driving and takes Wayne Bacon and Roberto McBride for a ride and gets the first down for Tennessee. Great individual effort by Jason Witten.
Really attracted attention with an outstanding spring. Coming into the day, he had only 9 catches, 7 so far. Here's Stevens inside the 25-yard line. Tackle is made by Herschel Bolden, a gain of 7 for Travis Stevens.
Again, one of the things I'm most impressed with Casey Clawson is he takes what the defense gives him. You see, the tight end has been the go-to guy today. Finlayson has one, and the rest belong to Jason Witten. But you've got receivers that are a little banged up. Kelly Washington not 100% with the foot. Dante Stallworth not 100% with the wrist. And you find the tight end and make him be a big weapon for you.
Second down and 3, a 3-point margin in this game. That's Witten in motion. They'll hand it off to Stevens. It's going to bring forth another third down. And let's get some more on the tight end story from Jill Arrington.
Well, as you can see, they're getting their tight ends much more involved today, and that could be a direct result of the offensive coaching staff went down to Nashville and visited the NFL's Tennessee Titans to learn more about how to get their tight ends more involved. Seems to be paying off today.
Titans have got a pretty good one in Frank Wycheck.
They sure do, and they know how to get them the football. Pretty good place to go and study that.
9:28 to go, 3rd and 2 at the 23. Randy Sanders, the offensive coordinator for Philip Fulmer. They've loaded up on the left side. They toss it. Here goes Stevens left. What a big block he got. I think it was the tight end, Witten, again.
Well, Salim Rashid is coming on a blitz, and he almost gets there to trip up Stevens in the backfield. Watch Rashid come through on the blitz and then end up chasing Travis Stevens. He's unblocked, but he just can't quite get it and before Stevens gets it upfield for the first down. A nice play call by Randy Sanders, going with the toss sweep, anticipating the inside blitz.
9:13 to go, 1st and 10, Tennessee. They trail by 3. Play fake, Clawson avoids a tackle of Moorhead, and then he is down at the 14-yard line. Brooks Daniels, number 18 for Alabama, got there.
You know, I don't think Casey Clawson ever intended to throw that. He looked like he was going to run all the way. He's got to put his shoe back on. Better get it on quick, or he's going to have to come out for a play.
It's not on. Second and six. Sanders calling the play. Second down, six from the 14. Stevens knocked backwards. Gained one. Darius Gilbert, number 99.
He's in there to give Salim Rashid a little break. And he does what you hope a backup would do in that situation, not have a drop-off in productivity. Darius Gilbert, a veteran guy, a senior, made a big play there. Very
Another
important
third down.
Play. Yeah, this may be the biggest third down play in the ballgame right now. Third and five from inside the 15-yard line.
Parker and Graham go left. Stallworth wide right.
Washington and Stallworth both on the same side, down at the bottom here.
Low snap, Clawson has it, drills it. Kelly Washington, first and goal, Tennessee.
Strength, Vern, strength. I mean, this is a 225-pound receiver, and he just was able to kind of throw off the coverage of Wayne Bacon. Watch Bacon, he's got his hands on it, but watch Washington just throw him off with his right arm and free up for the reception. That's just a physical wide receiver. He's not 100%, but that was a huge contribution for the Tennessee team.
All three catches have come here in the second half. Stallworth goes wide left now on first and goal with 7:17 to go in the ball game. Stevens, contact made behind the line. He spins and is down at the 3-yard line.
The other thing that's going on right now, and this is what Tennessee is outstanding at, is they are eating up time here in the fourth quarter. It's a time-consuming drive. They're mixing the run and the pass. They're not throwing incompletion, so the clock keeps running. We're down around 6 minutes and 50 seconds. You take a look at what Tennessee has done to all their opponents in the fourth quarter. This is when they really take charge of football games. And Dennis Franchione does not want to see that happen in this one.
On second, the toss right. Stevens gets a block at the goal line. He's tackled at the one.
Nice play by Rashid. Tennessee tried to trick him with a quick count, and Travis is a little woozy. He doesn't look good. Watch this now. Salim Rashid, it was a quick count, so they kind of caught Alabama getting in position, but Rashid, with the quick reaction, gets there. At the end of the play, Brooks Daniels coming over the top. Yeah, knee right in the head of Travis Stevens.
Travis Stevens remains down just off the field to play at the 1-yard line.
Obviously not an intentional thing by Brooks Daniels, just chasing the play and hustling, but caught him right in the side of the head with that knee.
Well, he comes right and is tackled by Rashid, who makes his 11th tackle. Time has been called. We'll return after this. Travis Stevens on the Tennessee bench with the injury. Corey Larkin's listed as a backup, suspended for one game. Cedric Houston, a freshman, Troy Fleming, and Will Bartholomew are in the backfield. Houston, number 21, Fleming, number 27. Touchdown, Clawson, Tennessee. What a great play-action fake.
Great call by Randy Sanders, and then patience by Casey Clawson. The key to this is making sure you sell the fake. Don't get out of there too quick, because if you do it right, they'll be totally fooled, and that's exactly what happened. Watch him sell the fake this way, and the whole Alabama defense reacts. Hide the ball, sell the fake, and then come out. Totally fooled the Alabama defense.
Go back a couple of games, Todd. Remember when Randy Sanders called a quarterback draw?
That's right.
Clawson against LSU. That's an 18-play drive. 18 plays. And it took almost 9 minutes. And Clawson strolls in for the go-ahead. Ball at Volunteers with an 85-yard drive on 17 plays and consumed almost 9 minutes. 6:06 to go now. 28-24, Tennessee has gone back on top.
Vern, both teams have answered the question about playing better in the fourth quarter. And right now, the ball is squarely back in Alabama's court.
Alex Walls will kick off. Carter and Millens await the kick. This one high will be returned. Millens at the three. Gets a block. Gets another block from Wayne Bacon. Nice return out to the 35-yard line. First block from Carter, second from Bacon. The Rigid Tool Scholar Athlete Award for today's game goes to University of Alabama's number 14, Tyler Watts. Rigid Tool's commitment to the investment of our future is shown today by donating $1,000 to the University of Alabama's General Scholarship Fund. Watts, a junior marketing major with a 3-point grade point average.
And Bernie's probably, like most Sundays, going to wake up pretty stiff, but that's just when you play in this offense, you're going to get hit a lot, and it won't feel nearly as bad if he can pull out a win here.
Back, right side, little drive, and again he's high.
Yep.
Again he is high.
And he knows it. Tennessee has been well prepared for the play action pass off the option. Both of the deep receivers were covered. This is the number three receiver, the tight end Theo Sanders. He just can't get the ball down. Actually, it was Terry Jones Jr., the intended receiver. He knows he's going to get hit, but that's a throw he's got to make.
Second down and 10, Alabama trailing by four with under six to go. Four wide receivers set for the Crimson Tide. Three to the left and one right. Almost intercepted. Andre Lott. Close to his first of the year.
Well, this was a checkoff by Tyler Watts, and Andre Lott very close to making this ball game just about history.
Pretty extraordinary. Here we are with 5:45 to go. No turnovers by either team thus far. Watts, very modest number throwing the ball. Third and 10. Watts has missed six of his last seven passes. Four-man rush by Tennessee. He goes left and one hops it to Antonio Carter.
Too much pressure on that one. He couldn't get through on the ball. The big rush supplied by Albert Haynesworth, number 92. He's been fairly quiet, but this time he comes right over the center and just pushes his man right back to the quarterback, and that prohibits Tyler Watts from making a good throw. That was a nice bull rush by Albert Haynesworth.
Watts goes to the sideline, fourth down, and Alabama will punt with 5:41 to go.
Now, the thing about punting here is you've got to play defense. You can't let Tennessee eat up the clock like they did on that last drive.
Fair catch. Called for and taken by Eric Parker at the 28-yard line, a 37-yard punt.
The problem is your defense just was on the field for 17 plays, and it's three and out, and they're right back out there again. They've got to suck it up now.
Now let's take a look at the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. Time of possession. Tennessee, this has been a factor in their success this year. For complete college football coverage, go to cbs.sportsline.com or AOL, keyword CBS Sportsline. First and 10, Volunteers. Stevens back on the field after having the wind knocked out of him. And he picks up 2 yards across the 30. Cornelius Wortham with the tackle. Coming up next week, we go to Jacksonville, Florida. Georgia comes from behind and wins today. Florida with a bye week, trying to forget the effects of a loss to Auburn. Georgia, Florida, next Saturday, 3:30, and it begins with Tim and Spencer at 3 o'clock Eastern on College Football Today. Second down and 7.
Jason Witten not in the game for Tennessee. Finlinson in. I would expect run if I was Alabama.
Quick hitch, left side, tipped. Aries Monroe, number 22, got a hand up.
Nice play. And good job on first down. You saw that graphic, Tennessee averaging 7 yards per play on first down. They held him on the first time to 3, and now it's third and 7. When we talked to Carl Torbush yesterday, he said the problem for his defense and not being able to win games in the fourth quarter is we haven't had anybody step up and make a play. They haven't been able to do that when they had the lead. Now, trailing by four, more than ever, they need somebody to step up and make a play. Tennessee, 8 of 13 on third downs in the ball game.
Again, the four wide receiver set, and Clawson will go with the spread. Kelly Washington, bottom of the screen against Gerald Dixon. Low snap. Three-man rush. They drop eight. Washington's open. Over-the-shoulder catch. Hauled down from behind. Bacon punches it out, but Stallworth is there to grab it.
Casey Clawson saw what he wanted. Single, Gerald Dixon, a short cornerback against his main guy, Kelly Washington. Bacon with a nice hustle play, but Stallworth there hustling just as well on the play. Alabama in their secondary, Vern, has not been able to come up with the big play when they need it. They just have given up too many plays like that.
54-yard play. First down inside the 15. Stevens, what a workhorse he's been. Loses his helmet. Durable back, not the biggest in the world. That's his 29th carry of the ball game. And talk about being sore on Sunday.
That was some kind of a collision between Brooks Daniels and Travis Stevens. Wow, that was some impact there. Helmet comes loose, but you notice Travis Stevens, without headgear, continues to move forward and pick up another yard or so.
4 minutes, 4 seconds to go. The numbers for the day, 160 for Travis Stevens, including the 60-yard touchdown run.
Alabama with two timeouts left. As the clock goes down to 3:45, they're going to have to start thinking about using them. Tennessee actually let it go down as far as they could and used one of their timeouts.
Clock is stopped with 3 minutes and 46 seconds to go. And let's take a look now at the Exxon and Mobil scoring recap. It was Stallworth, 21-yarder for the first touchdown. That made it 7-0. Alabama got a field goal, 7-3. Then this wonderful run. Great move by Travis Stevens, 60 yards, 14-10 at the break. Sam Collins caught two touchdowns as Alabama went back on top. And then Jason Witten with the first touchdown catch of his career. That followed by Ahmad Galloway. That gave Alabama a momentary lead of three, but Clawson on third and goal from the yard line, 1 yard line, with a quarterback keeper, and we stand at 28-24.
And Vern, I think the reason that Tennessee called that timeout, people may be wondering, I don't think they wanted to run a play without Travis Stevens on the field. If they're going to give the football to anybody, they wanted it to be number 34, so they let him get his helmet fixed.
From the 12, second down 7, Clawson left side, a little behind Dante Stallworth, and he was open.
Vern, we talked about fourth quarter. We talked about Philip Fulmer's team dominating the time and the play in the fourth quarter. That was the 22nd play Tennessee has run in the fourth quarter. How many plays has Alabama run? Three in the fourth quarter. And now they got it down in there in scoring territory again as well.
On third down, Stevens comes out. Washington back on the field. Third and 7 at the 12. Parker and Graham go wide left. Washington and Stallworth come to the near side.
Nobody's on Washington right now. They better get somebody out over top of him.
That's happened before. Here's the quarterback draw. Clawson up the middle, bounced down, but it's first and goal at the 2.5.
I'll tell you what, I know Randy Sanders has taken some heat as the play caller at Tennessee. I think he's done a great job today. He has made the right call at the right time. The quarterback draw, you mentioned it, Vern. They called this against LSU and got a big touchdown out of it. Now they get a huge first down out of the same play. Here's Randy Sanders right there, sending in the signals. See a lot of offensive coordinators up in the press box. He likes being on the field. He likes looking at his quarterback's eyes, looking at the offensive player's eyes. And I think he's done an excellent job today calling plays for Casey Clawson.
First and goal from the 3, Bartholomew, Fleming, and Stevens, all 3 in. The toss, Fleming tries to provide a block, but Dixon is there to help with the tackle. So is Wayne Bacon. Second down.
Now, Tennessee wants to get a score right now, but they don't. That play doesn't hurt them because the clock continues to run. And again, Carl Torbush and Dennis Franchione are going to have to think about calling a timeout. Maybe after this next play, they'll have to use one of their two remaining timeouts. And on the other side, Casey Clawson is telling his team, okay, now we're going to use as much time as we can. I'll take care of the play clock, but I'm going to let that play clock go down as far as I can before we snap the football.
As they get to the line, there are 8 seconds left on the play clock. Second down and goal from the three. Stevens. Third and goal from the three. Kenny King, number 55, made the tackle. Reminder, regional coverage, the NFL on CBS tomorrow. 1 o'clock games from Tampa, Indianapolis, Cleveland, and Detroit. 4 o'clock games from San Diego and Arizona. And it begins with the NFL today, 12 noon Eastern time tomorrow on CBS. Under two to go, third and goal.
What Dennis Franchione's thinking right now is he's going to save his timeouts for his offense. If they get a stop here, even if Tennessee gets a field goal, Alabama is still only a touchdown behind.
Toss, Fleming going left, Bartholomew with the block. Did not get in.
Here's
now
the
NFL timeout.
Yep. Here's the timeout. So there's a minute 30 left, and they still have one timeout in their pocket. A nice play by Alabama. It looked like Tennessee had him outflanked. Bacon able to stay on his feet and stay in position, but Rashid, as he does time after time, comes up and makes the key play. Dennis Franchione sends Thurman Ward in and says, call the timeout, 28-24.
1:28 to go in the game. Fourth down and goal from the 1 yard line. Interesting decision now by the Tennessee Volunteers.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, they're warming up Alex Walls, but the thinking also might be fourth and one, go for it with your offense. Even if you don't make the touchdown, you make Alabama go 99 yards against the best defense in the SEC to beat you. They need a touchdown to win, and it looks like that's what Philip Fulmer's saying. He puts Casey Clawson and the offense back out there, and they're going to go for the touchdown. But even if they don't make it, Alabama has 99 to go to tie the game or to win the game.
Fourth and goal from the one. The toss, Stevens comes right. Got it, touchdown.
Jason Witten got away with a huge hold on Shantu Ray. It was not called. And give credit to Travis Stevens for getting in the end zone, but watch Jason Witten right here. He's going to get a block on Shantu Ray, and he's got a hold of his arm and will not let go. And Ray not able to get to the end to make the play on Stevens.
Will Bartholomew got a handful of jersey, too. Stevens, 162 yards on 33 carries.
What a workhorse.
Extra point up and good. Worth another look.
You just cannot say enough about Travis Stevens. Yeah, maybe there was a hold. Maybe there were two holds on the play. But Travis Stevens was not going to be denied. And a gutsy call by Philip Fulmer and Randy Sanders, and it paid off for the Volunteers.
Balls by 11. Jared Johnson. The early part of the last century actually goes from the 19th century into the 20th. Sewanee defeated Alabama 6 times in succession. The University of Tennessee has defeated Alabama the last 6 years in succession. No one has ever defeated them 7 years running.
You know, Vern, I know they say in football you could call holding on every play if you wanted to.
I've heard that.
Boy, oh boy. I mean, that's a tough call to make at that point in the game, but man, oh man.
There were a couple of close encounters. Tennessee on Alabama defenders. Here's Freddie Millins. No, not on that one. Well, lengthening shadows here at Bryant-Denny Stadium on the campus of the University of Alabama, and these spectacular views from above. Brought to you by the Saturn Light Shift. Today marks the first appearance of the Saturn Light Shift on a regular season college football game. Nice to have him with us.
Yep. You know, the big question now that Alabama people have got to be wondering is, will we see a different finish to the season than we did last year?
Watts very close for a safety. He's going to be ruled down at the one. Kevin Burnett, number two.
Well, right now, Tennessee is thinking pass all the way. They bring a blitz. Galloway doesn't pick up the blitz, and Tyler Watts pays for it. Last year at this time, Alabama was 3-3. They went to Knoxville. They got beat, and they finished 3-8. And they were going definitely downward from that point on.
Corner blitz. Watts gets it out. Dropped by Carter. It'll be third down. You know, we spent time with Dennis Franchione yesterday, though, and talked about the possibility of this being a turnaround game. Yeah. And he said, I'm not going to call it that.
Yeah. He said that we've got four games to play. Now, if we win, he'll make it a turnaround game. Well, it doesn't look like they're going to win. And he's going to keep them on that same page of playing the next play, playing the next game, and trying to finish strong. And for Tennessee, a huge win on the road that puts them right back in the thick of things in the SEC East.
Watts flips it out, called by Santonio Beard. And he gets out of bounds, but he gets out of bounds 2 yards short of the yardage needed for a first down.
Can't say enough about the key players for Tennessee today. Casey Clawson played an outstanding ball game. Travis Stevens, an outstanding ball game. His two best receivers a little bit banged up, so he found a new target in Jason Witten, the tight end.
Fourth and 12. And Watts will go for it. Santonio Beard, the ball will go over on downs, and the Volunteers looks like they're going to be lighting up the cigars after this week. That's a tradition that goes back to Bear Bryant in 1961 when the Bears team, the national champions of Paul Bear Bryant in 1961 when they defeated Tennessee in that game, handed out the cigars.
Dennis Franchione, the thing that he's got to deal with his team, for the third straight SEC game, they had a lead going into the fourth quarter, and they lost the ball game. Alabama's last four offensive possessions, three and outs, and 1 4 and out. Not the way you want to play in the fourth quarter if you want to be a great football team.
Yeah.
I mean, they came to play today. There's no question. This was a good football game. Both teams executed and played well, but when it counted in the end, Tennessee was the much better team in the fourth quarter.
Clawson will take a knee. And for the first time in Alabama football history, a team has conquered them 7 years in a row. Philip Fulmer, who was recruited by Bear Bryant, opted to stay at home. He grew up in Tennessee. Said they recruited him, did Tennessee as the next great linebacker for the Volunteers. He wound up as a pretty good offensive guard. Philip Fulmer and the Volunteers win it 35-24. They go to 4-1. And they are right back in the thick of things in the Southeastern Conference East Division.
It'll be a much better week for Philip this week. He had a rough week after that Georgia game. People starting to rumble a little bit. He's kind of been the victim of his own success at Tennessee. They've been so good. The expectations are so high. And they answered the call today.
And Jill Arrington is with Philip Fulmer. Let's go down to the field.
Well, Coach, congratulations. You keep that win streak against Alabama alive, 7 in a row now. How were you able to really turn it on there in the fourth quarter?
Well, obviously, our offense got things going pretty good. Our tight end made some huge plays. Jason Witten just kind of been looking for that breakout game. Casey Clawson just played fabulous. Our little back, our whole group of kids, we have fought and scratched and haven't been a really healthy football team all year. We got some guys back today and showed an awful lot of character and heart and toughness against a very determined Alabama football team. You've got to take your hats off to them as well.
Travis Stevens played great for you, a big workhorse out there today with 33 carries. What do you think of his play getting in that end zone?
Travis is one of those guys that everybody doubted, you know, and we all, you know, we wouldn't have won the national championship in 98 without Travis Stevens. And, you know, he just got a great heart and great determination and really good ability. So I'm proud of him and for him.
And how are your emotions feeling of this whole big rivalry that just keeps going year after year?
Well, it's unbelievable. You know, I have such great respect for Alabama and their tradition, as everybody does. And having been down here as a prospect myself, you know, it has a lot to it. And you think about all the great games and the great coaches and the great players that have been in those football games. And to be a part of that history and actually to make history here today was really, really special. And I'm proud of our football team and our staff.
Well, Coach, enjoy this win. And Casey Clawson, you're here with me. You had a huge game today. You were able to really spread the ball around, even got your tight ends involved.
Yeah, all the credit goes to my teammates. We came out, and it was a big game for us coming out. We executed and made plays and got the win.
You sure did stay poised in such a big ball game. How are you able to really keep your head in the game and make some big decisions?
The biggest thing is just stay focused. I got confidence in my teammates. And like I said, it was a game for us that we need to come out and play well. And we had guys step up, make plays. And defense a great whole game. Gave us the ball back, and it was a great win for us.
All right, well, congratulations. Enjoy it. Back up to you guys.
All right, Jill, thank you for the day. The sophomore quarterback, Casey Clawson, 21 of 28, just under 300 yards, 2 touchdowns, no interceptions,
yep.
No turnovers in the ball game, and Clawson's record as a starter for Tennessee now goes to 10-2 and 8-1 in SEC. But what a workhorse effort by the running back, Travis Stevens, today. 162 yards on 33 carries, averaging just a shade under 5 yards per carry, 2 touchdowns, 1 from 60 yards away, the other from a yard out, and he is our Army player of the game. Final score, 35-24, Volunteers defeat Alabama for the 7th consecutive year.